tangle in the eagle's nest. Hello, everyone. Dick Enberg with Bob Trumpy. Headline news, if even put Bill Clinton down on the front page of the Inquirer on Tuesday. Headlines again today. Cunningham sits down. Jim McMahon takes over at quarterback.
And you know, Dick, when we talk to the Philadelphia Eagles, they bring up a lot of names. Names of guys who are not here. Buddy Ryan mentioned Keith Jackson. It's on the mind of the Eagles. Andre Waters, the great safety, out with a broken leg. And this team never stops talking about the memory of Jerome Brown.
Cunningham, it is promised, will start against Green Bay next week. McMahon gets the call today. Art Schell, the Raider coach, knows all about benching quarterbacks. Jay Schrader had the game of his life, the best ever by the Raiders on the road earlier this year. Next game, he's on the bench.
He hands it over to the kid, Todd Marinovich, a college senior by age. He's going to need a lot of help from the running game because I'm telling you, Dick, this Philadelphia Eagle defense preys on young quarterbacks.
Marinovich wearing that familiar number 12. The southpaw Ken Stabler carried so magnificently in Raider lore. Ruzek tees it up, and the Raiders will have a chance on offense first. Some of the Raiders, Bob, actually thought there was an insult that McMahon was starting, not Cunningham.
Yeah, you know, Dick, when I think Ronnie Lott made that comment to us, I got the feeling that he's looking for inspiration in this football game. They've won three of their last four, but any little thing that a great player like Ronnie Lott can put in his mind as an inspiration against the Philadelphia Eagles or any other opponent, it helps, but I don't think it's true.
Rich Kotite, even with all the mystique about the quarterback this week in Philadelphia, said, I heard that Jay Schrader is going to start, not Marinovich, as if we could confirm that. He said, I have a reliable source. Even coaches do. And here we go. The Eagles hungry for a win. The Raiders trying to get to 4-4. Napoleon McCallum at the 8. And the former Navy star to the 27. Marinovich brings on the Raider offense. Low scoring, and the passing game has not been very productive. Rich Kotite will counter with his tough defense. Stingiest along with Pittsburgh, number one in the league. Wilkerson, Wisniewski, Mosebar, Pete McElroy, the big offensive line. Max Montoya is healthy but will not start. He is in uniform for the Raiders. Marinovich has Smith and Eric Dickerson, number two all-time. Gold and Brown outside. Ethan Horton, the tight end. We'll see Marcus Allen on third downs and the speedster Alexander Wright, the NFL's fastest man. Dickerson gets three on first down. Maybe four on the lean to the 31. Reggie White, the all-pro defensive end, makes the tackle. Here's his company in green. Harmon Golick, the younger brother of Bob. Clyde Simmons has nine sacks. Joyner, Evans, and Thomas. Bud Carson said they cover better than any set of linebackers he's ever coached. That covers some territory. Booty and Allen on the corner. Allen's a pro bowler. Miano and Hopkins at safety, and Otis Smith comes in the nickel. This year. On second down, Marinovich underneath to Tim Brown, right at the sticks at the 37-yard line. Looks as if it'll be a half yard short. Hopkins comes up to make the hit.
Dick, if you're a Raider fan, a secret to the Raiders' success today is not throwing the obvious throwing situations. That was second down and medium yards. The underneath pattern, nice little pick run by the tight end. Clears out in the middle, but you can't get in third down in long situations if you're the Raiders, because then you turn over your quarterback to the best pass rush in the last 2 years in the NFL.
And of course, even tougher with Jerome Brown, the inspiration of this Eagle team, killed in a tragic automobile accident during the off year. They talked about, and Hopkins, who made that last tackle, that Marinovich bird dogs.
Yeah, you can learn a lot of offense meeting with Mike White in the classroom, watching film. But this is a very young player in Todd Marinovich, and young players lock onto a receiver. And when they lock onto a receiver, defensive backs just stand there and read his eyes.
Bird dog, like pointing to where you're going to go. Third and inches. Marcus Allen on third down. As promised, it'll be close, and we all know around the National Football League how tough that defense of the Eagles can be in short yardage. Ask the Phoenix Cardinals with six shots from the 1 yard line, couldn't knock it home.
I have a feeling too that Rich Kotite likes the idea he starts this big game at home with his defense on the field.
First down, as Allen needed only inches and didn't get much more than that, maybe a foot.
The reason I say that about the defense is the defense, generally speaking, in the NFL, sets the tone for the day. Your defense lays a lick on their offense. That's the tone of the day. So Kotite likes this first series matchup.
Dickerson back in, but it's Steve Smith, the fullback, a rare carry, and he takes a punishing hit as filling the gap was Byron Evans, number 56. And those around the Eagles say this man, Evans, while he's lived in the shadow of Seth Joyner and Reggie White and others, is a true Pro Bowl talent.
Ask him yesterday, too, if you can describe yourself. And he said, well, Joyner on the outside, he's the hitter. He said, I'm the guy who is the steady one. I stay inside, I don't make mistakes, and I don't like my opponent, whoever he is.
And he does like the results yesterday of his alma mater, Arizona, over Washington. Second and eight. Good protection. Intercepted off the hands of Willie Gault and right into the midst of Eric Allen. Allen's second of the year, a gift. Gault had it. And it bounded out of his grasp right to number 21, Eric Allen.
From behind the offense, certainly can't put this on Todd Marinovich. It's a simple out pattern run by Gault. It's not that cold. That ball is certainly catchable. Should have been by Willie Gault. Certainly a bad start. Marinovich does not throw a particularly hard pass. Inexcusable to drop that one.
So the Eagles take over at the 47-yard line. Los Angeles second worst in the turnover ratio in the league. And a penalty on first down. Whoa. And as missing the count was Antone Davis. He was going downfield like a wide receiver. Let's go back to the interception.
Dick, you made the point. Very good. There was nice protection for Marinovich. The ball is thrown on spiral. But this baby bounces off Willie Gault's hands like he's got him on backwards.
So, 5-yard penalty as Davis moving before the snap. There's Eric Allen. He doesn't get many chances. Most teams throw away from his coverage because of his talent. First and 15 for McMahon. Fires out of the backfield. He's hit for a loss by Eddie Anderson. Now Anderson, second in tackles to Ronnie Lott, the two safeties leading the Raiders in hits. Adds a deficit on first and 15 as Byers loses a couple.
Dick, the same is true for this Philadelphia offense. They want to run the ball with Herschel Walker, be very conservative. But when you get a 5-yard penalty on first and 10 and you got to sit there first and 15, now second and 20, you are playing to the strength of the Raiders defense, which is the pass rush. That little screen, not even close to working.
Calvin Williams to the right. Fred Barnett to the left. Look for the tight end, Maurice Johnson, 87. They have not thrown to him this year. And down goes McMahon as Howie Long, who played his college football here in the city of brotherly love for Villanova University. Long, who's having a solid season, and this his 12th year, has 6.5 sacks.
He's on the second year pro, Antone Davis. Howie Long just ejects Davis out of his way, still with great strength. He's playing all over the line. Plays some nose tackle, some defensive end. What was his line to you yesterday at practice? And you said, give me one Villanova story. They were homecoming opponents.
For 22 straight opponents while he was there.
That's
Everyone wanted Villanova for homecoming. But they won yesterday against New Hampshire. A big win here in Division II. Boy, what a series by the Raider defense. 8-yard loss on that last play. Now McMahon, third and long, gets it to veteran Roy Green. Far short of the first down, out at the 45-yard line. Terry McDaniel makes the hit. And that'll bring up fourth down and about 18.
Well, in that series, we saw great pressure by the Raider defensive line. They didn't come with a blitz, just a 4-man rush. And I think that's a concern for Rich Kotite, Jim McMahon, and the Philadelphia Eagles. The offensive line has not really held up its end in the last 4 or 5 weeks here for Philadelphia.
Very important series with the interception in Raider territory. Eagles having the ball, and the defense did the job. So Jeff Fiegelt of the Eagles gets it away. A beautiful high spiral. Brown will let it bounce, and it takes an eagle bounce. Out of bounds or down at the 5-yard line. Majestic 50-yarder by Fegels. When we come back, the Raiders will tee it up at their own 5.
It's a refreshing taste from a cold, cold place. Yeah, it's easy going down from the very first round. Pure as can be, it's a natural, you see.
Wow.
It's smooth, smooth, silver bullet smooth.
Yeah.
Well, that's our story. Now it's your call. Cold Coors Light is the right beer now. That's all. Bye-bye.
Starting now, your photos have the power of television. Introducing the Kodak Photo CD.
You won't believe your heart. You won't believe your eyes.
Your pictures taken with your current film and camera, transferred onto a new kind of compact disc, and shown on TV. The special Photo CD player also plays audio CDs.
Your pictures have never been so powerful.
The new Kodak Photo CD system. You've got to see it.
So, I see you changed your mind, huh?
Well, the Camry was nice.
Mm-hmm.
And then I drove this.
Yeah.
Mileage is better.
Really? And with the power, I'm telling you, it's like a sports car with room for the kids.
Probably set you back, huh?
About 3,000 less than the Camry.
No kidding.
No kidding.
Well, what is it?
The new Grand Am. It's a Pontiac.
We are trying. Excitement. Pontiac.
Really looks nice.
Philadelphia Eagles in a scoring slump in the last four games. They get an opportunity. Interception at the Raider 47. Move backwards. The defense of Los Angeles doing the job. And now the punt. And it's Todd Marinovich and company starting at the 5-yard line. And Willie Gault eager to get back in action and make amends for his misplay that led to an interception. He was out of the huddle long before everyone else. Now the crowd will try to bolster the Eagle defense. Before the snap, and that'll cost Los Angeles.
Well, he was going to throw there, too. Play action fake by Marinovich. He was going to toss it.
Check at the other early scores as they move through
ball
our ticket.
Start. Number 77 offense moving prior to the snap. Half the distance to the goal, still first down.
Tom White, the referee, announcing that Reggie McElroy playing at tackle for injured Steve Wright.
I don't blame him for trying to be anxious on these pass plays. He is across from Reverend Reggie White.
Dickerson gets back to 2.5, so it'll be 2nd and 10 as Britt Hager comes in, young man from Texas, to make the stop.
We've talked a lot about the Philadelphia Eagles, but on the Raiders' side of the ball, there's Marcus Allen on the sideline, has been demoted as he is the third string back behind Eric Dickerson, and Nick Bell, number 38 right there, is not sure why.
Well, just as the Raiders were happy it was McMahon, not Cunningham, at quarterback, felt they could defend him better, so were the Eagles pleased that Marcus Allen isn't going to play much, as they're more fearful of him than either Dickerson or Bell.
It's also a mystery to Marcus Allen, too, as to why this situation exists.
What are they trying to do? Torture me? From his own end zone. Oh, that deflected by Mike Golick. But Simmons was there, and so was Reggie White. There's Golick, who is some 6 years younger than Bob.
From behind the offense. Look, they got Eric Dickerson trying to block Clyde Simmons. Not. Please, watch the 29. This, oh, Eric Dickerson, oh, no, please, no, not, no, no, don't put me on this. And Marinovich is saying, I'm not calling that play again, no matter what comes in.
3rd and 10. His dad, Louie, from Cleveland here to watch the two sons. Bob, who has also been demoted, is on the bench. Out in the starting defensive four for the Raiders. 3rd and 10, and Smith gets only a couple of yards and barely took the snap before the play clock ran out.
And Dick, in the last 4 weeks, we got a fight going on here. You know, Byron Evans, he likes to hit him in the mouth and don't help him up off the field, number 56 there. But this in capsule form is what's happened to the Eagles in the last 3 or 4 weeks. Defense does its job, get a turnover, stop the offense. Offense can't produce.
Hale, the offense about to get another opportunity as Jeff Gossett will kick from his own end zone to Vi Sikahema, the veteran, and the rookie, Jeff Seidner. Bad kick. Out of bounds inside the Raider 40. Let's see where they mark it. At the 37-yard line, so the Eagles, two possessions, both in Raider territory.
This isn't the Accord of the Camry you were talking about.
I know.
This is so sporty.
I got a V6 engine and standard anti-lock brakes.
Is it fun to drive?
It's great. The control and the power, you know, for passing and that kind of thing. And it was a couple thousand less than the Accord of the Camry.
Really? What is this?
It's a Pontiac, the new Grand Am.
Good for you.
A puzzle. With so many stomach remedies around, how do you know which you can take for heartburn? And for diarrhea? And for upset stomach? You take Pepto-Bismol to relieve most any common stomach problem, heartburn, upset stomach, and diarrhea. So who needs anything else? That is a puzzle. Pepto-Bismol is the only one you need.
Hi, Super Dave Osborne here with Haeger Wrinkle-Free Cotton Pants. They look great right out of the dryer with no ironing, but Haeger's asked me to put them to the ultimate test. I'll wear these pants through high-pressure jets, brushes, and dryers at 3 miles per hour. Ready? Oh, we're out of time. I guess Haeger will have to pay me for another commercial. Maybe not! Oh! Ow! Uh-oh!
New Haeger Wrinkle-Free Cottons. 100% cotton, 0% wrinkles.
They're still not wrinkled!
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Coors Light. The silver bullet is the right beer now. By the 25th anniversary diamond, a brilliant celebration of the loving marriage. By Schick Tracer, it traces every curve on your face. And by Pontiac and your nearby Pontiac dealers, we are driving excitement.
Todd Marinovich trying to find some answers from Tom Walsh, who calls the plays while Jim McMahon goes to work at the Raider 37-yard line after the 29-yard Gossett punt. So the Eagles, excellent field position again. McMahon wide open, Calvin Williams breaks a tackle out of bounds inside the 15. Yards for the former Purdue receiver.
See, right in the middle of the picture, it's Eddie Anderson. This is zone coverage by the Raiders. They just find a dead spot. And Jim McMahon, an excellent job of making that completion. Randy Lott misses the tackle. Keith Byers, a little assist down the field. Yeah, anything like that that the Philadelphia Eagles can get here just really helps in the early stages of this game.
Inside the 10 before Ronnie Lott can rattle off a tackle. Byers, who is number two in rushing with 143 yards of the running backs, but averaging over 5 a carry. Such a terrific talent because he can run the ball. He's an excellent receiver, one of the best, and he has thrown 5 touchdown passes in his NFL career.
He will also block you on your can, too. He is the complete player.
Again, and not much there. Willie Broughton submarining, and Greg Townsend 93 there as well. Roy Green, the veteran, comes in, and McMahon and Green have a simpatico that might suggest that you should watch for Green in this situation.
Yeah, call each other coach constantly. Coach McMahon, Coach Green, of course. Two-way player when he was with St. Louis early in his career.
First 2 years, drafted as a defensive back. Shotgun, Third and four. Fake to Walker, and he throws it away. Good coverage by the Raiders, so the Eagles will have to settle for three.
Looked like the intended receiver was Keith Byers. Anthony Bell, number 59, was all over him. The Eagles did an awful lot there. They had motion, faking a handoff up underneath Jim McMahon. It did not fool the Raiders one bit. This is a missed opportunity here. The field position they got would come out with just three.
Rozek will try a 24-yard field goal. Fortunately for the players today, not much wind to contend with. He skids one through. Not by much. In fact, the Raiders thought it was wide. Timeout, 6:21 to go in the opening quarter. The Eagles on the board first.
Just because you got 2.3 kids. Just because you got a house, a lawn, and a mortgage. Just because you're now a responsible adult. You still know how to have a good time. Don't you? The new Grand Am Sports Sedan.
Every 20 seconds, a car is stolen. So Liberty Mutual is giving some police a powerful homing device that finds the car, which lowers insurance. And this device also finds the thief, who finds himself behind bars.
At Liberty Mutual, we're facing the issues that face our customers.
Alka-Seltzer Plus Nighttime now has a maximum strength cough suppressant and a maximum strength antihistamine. So you get the relief you need to rest without alcohol. Alka-Seltzer Plus Nighttime. Tough medicine without alcohol.
This high-performance drink cleans your fuel system to help maintain peak performance. STP Gas Treatment. The high-performance drink for your car.
Eagles 3 and the Raiders nothing. 6:21 left in the first quarter. Ruzek has it teed up. Jim McMahon, one good play, the 24-yard pass to Calvin Williams, but that about it, with two terrific opportunities, one at the Raider 47, the other starting at the 37. The Eagles get but 3 points. And now Alexander Wright, the speedster, fastest in the NFL, and McCallum are deep. They kick toward McCallum. At the one. The little cornerback, Mark McMillan, makes the stop. He's only 5'7", about 170 pounds.
Dick, back to that play run by Philadelphia. This is third and four. Motion here, fake draw here. They bring this guy out. They're going to run a screen, and he just throws it out of bounds. When we talked to Randall Cunningham, he said, you know, the offense has changed. In 1991, it was one thing. Now there's a lot of different formations and stuff. This may be an example of what he's talking about. Why go with all the junk there, third and four, inside the 15? Strange call.
Raiders continue to start deep in their own end. The protection. Oh, right into the teeth of three Eagle defenders. Tim Brown, the lonely Raider, and fortunately overthrown.
Dick, when you mentioned three defenders, Todd Marinovich was looking right at Tim Brown, drew every defensive back in the area right there. This is something that this young man is going to have to learn, and learn quickly, that you can't stare at that receiver. You've got to at least look off some of these defensive backs. Now, watching this ball, one, two, I mean, that's a crowd you can't throw into.
Dickerson, he isn't what he once was. The second leading rusher of all time behind Walter Payton. But Dickerson this year with 347 yards to lead the Raiders, but only a 3.7 average. And you can see the average per carry Getting down under the fours on legs that are 32 years old, although he's never had a serious injury. He just doesn't seem to have that pop, extra shot gear that he had when he first arrived with the Raiders.
And Dickerson, when he was young, that first two or three steps to the line of scrimmage from the backfield was extraordinary. Not there anymore.
As if he was catapulted forward. Marcus Allen replaces him, and
Dick, do they award quarter sacks? I think all four of them got there.
Said at the 5:17 mark of the first quarter, let's all meet at Marinovich.
Reggie White over on the left-hand side. Normally on the right-hand side. That time he was on Wilkerson. But White's there. Marinovich is seeing this cave in. He looks downfield. There's Simmons on the right, White on the left. Normally they're the other way around. But I count 1, 2, 3, 4 Eagle defensive linemen on Todd Marinovich.
So Philadelphia is going to get the ball probably in Raider territory again as the two deepmen set up at the 50-yard line, and Gossett booms one out of there. Terrific kick this time. Seidner all the way to his 40. 50. And hit at the 47 of Los Angeles. 52-yard kick, 13 on the return. Dan Turk made the stop for Los Angeles. Timeout. 4:36 left in the opening period.
Wow, he looked scarier 25 years ago.
Did I?
You looked scared.
I don't know. I thought I hit it well for an innocent groom.
You were innocent for the 60s.
Any regrets?
None. You?
Just one.
What?
That I waited 25 years to give you this.
The 25th anniversary diamond, a brilliant celebration of a loving marriage.
I've got goosebumps.
Well, you've given me goosebumps for 25 years.
I'm sure you work in an office.
I'm here till 8 o'clock.
What do you mean, 8?
But you live on the phone, which is why you should know about CentraNet service from GTE. With CentraNet, you get the features and flexibility of the most sophisticated business telephone system. Not the high cost of one.
It's really, really difficult for me right now.
Because while you spend most of your time on the phone,
he's gone now.
There's no need to spend most of your money.
Yeah, I looked at the BMW and the Lexus.
And?
I drove this. The power, the handling, the control. It was incredible.
Really?
It's got leather, ABS, dual airbags. It's even supercharged. I could have spent a lot more on the BMW or the Lexus. But why?
What is this?
The new Pontiac SSEI.
We are driving.
Very nice.
Excitement, Pontiac.
Mac is back, and in talking with Jim McMahon, he said, I just want to get back to the bowl, meaning the Super Bowl, as he led the Bears in 85, almost a perfect season, and he was ruining the opportunity. He said, we should have been, meaning the Chicago Bears, the team of the 80s, not the 49ers.
But the 49ers beat him in a couple of big games, and he admitted, hey, they beat us one time in Chicago. This guy's different.
What an understatement of the season. From the 47, three straight possessions starting in Raider territory. Man outside to Williams, who is carried out of bounds with the momentum, a short gain of 4, and a little extra hitting after the bell. Mo Johnson and Winston Moss. McMahon, a courageous a substitute for Cunningham last year, he told us that he had a fractured right elbow and tendon torn away. In fact, there's a cadaver ligament in there to allow him to continue this year. And he said, I'd just be in so much pain all week long. And then he would take a certain shot on Sunday morning, and he'd go out and perform. And Eagles almost made it to the playoffs, finished 7-1. Down, incomplete, intended for the tight end Maurice Johnson, who played his college ball here in the city at Temple. Aaron Wallace,
goodness,
on the coverage.
Eagles not doing much here offensively. This is Howie Long. He's untouched. They're trying to trick Howie Long. Howie Long is too much of a veteran. He's seen too many rollouts to buy that fact. Stays right there to get in Jim McMahon's face. You know, The one comment I got to make about Jim McMahon is with the headbands he wore in Chicago, the funny sunglasses, the strange comments, really hid a spectacular performance for years for the Chicago Bears. Also hid the fact that he's one of the game's great competitors.
He's his own distraction. He said, I do that to amuse myself. He goes on top this time, and Barnett with a diving try at the 5-yard line. So fourth down, and the punting team comes on. So McMahon unable to kickstart this slumbering Eagle offense.
This Barnett running the pattern, the initial move at the line of scrimmage, when you've got bump and run of the corners are up there pressing, he beats Lionel Washington like a drum. But I'm telling you, about this point, the defense of Philadelphia could sue the offense for non-support, and they've got evidence, strong evidence.
Eagles, and it's Tim Brown, the fair catch at the 11-yard line. And the pattern of this first quarter is the Eagles with great field position opportunity in the Raider half of the field, and Los Angeles starting very deep near its own goal line. A reminder, next Saturday, don't miss NBA Inside Stuff, the entertainment show of the NBA, hosted by our friends Hamad Rashad and Willow Bay. Inside Stuff takes to the streets. It's a special coverage of the Ultimate Playground 3-on-3 tournament. Don't miss the crowning of the Hoop It Up champion. Competition hits its final hour. It's all Saturday morning on NBC. Check your local listings. The NBA season underway. That's the Raiders' start. They got a first down and then the interception. And then three and out the last two. Dickerson. A little delay, and Dickerson slams out for about 10 yards before Wes Hopkins can trip him up.
Nice lead block right up in front of him, too. Steve Smith, number 35, for years considered one of the great lead blockers. Look at that hit on Evans. Drives him right out of there. This Philadelphia Eagle up front four, they consume people, allow the linebackers to make the tackles. And when Smith can just park Byron Evans 5 yards deep, yeah, you're going to gain yards.
10 yards, in fact, for a first down. Contact before the snap. Golic jumping into Steve Wisniewski. Was he drawn off?
He's the Golic playing today, which has been historically not the case. Bob has done most of the playing.
And Mike, he said, you have the shorter hair because I want to be Dad's favorite son. They both have a tremendous sense of humor, and of course, Mike following Bob to Notre Dame and then to the NFL. Both men early in their pro careers were kind of cast aside. Bob by the Patriots and Mike by Houston, and then became eventual starters, and for Bob, at least, a pro bowler. Dickerson across the 30 on first and five, as the penalty was against Mike Golic, and it'll be second and two. And there's going back a few years, Bob and baby Mike. Of course, Mike said he never was a baby. He was born on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of September.
Those were his formative years, though, certainly on all fours. Made him used to be a nose tackle, you know. But I asked Mike, Dad's here. Who do they root for? And their response is, he roots for the defense, not for the team.
And it's painful for Mike to watch Bob not playing. And Bob, you can see, almost a hurt in his pace. As Dickerson applying a little hurt on that charge. Now, that had a little spice to the Dickerson effort. And Miano comes up from the safety spot to make the tackle. But it's first down Raiders.
Again, you saw the lead ball blocked by Smith, but he abandons him, and free safety Rich Miano sticks his helmet right in there. That's the spot played by Andre Waters. Whoever plays that spot has got to be a big hitter in this Bud Carson defense.
This series beginning at the 12-yard line, a couple of first downs as Dickerson has been the workhorse. And at the half remaining in the opening quarter, Eagles lead 3-0.
What recovery speed. Goodness. It was not thrown with great steam on it. You can see Allen looking in the backfield. He watched when he stops. He reads the set. Now watch the closure. Actually, Willie Gault should have had that one, too. I'd change gloves if I were Willie right now.
They love the man cover talent of Eric Allen, who played at Arizona State. San Diego native. Marinovich now 1 for 5 for 5 yards and one interception. Not his fault. This is where the Eagles like to tee off. Play action. Chance of catching it than did Steve Smith.
Another floater. He had pressure in his face. Watch the left side of the screen. You see the pressure? The rollout. Clyde Simmons right there. It floats, and Wes Hopkins, the other safety on this team, again gives the Philadelphia Eagles unbelievable field position. That ball is tipped by Clyde Simmons. You can't go into a game as a head coach and expect to have field position like Philadelphia is getting here. Where's Herschel Walker? Use him now. Get the ball in the end zone.
That's right. Walker hasn't had his number called yet. Hopkins' third interception gives him 29 in his career. He's close to becoming the all-time pass theft in Philadelphia history. Bill Bradley at 34. And now Walker, hearing the advice from the stands, the Eagles go to the former Heisman winner and Winston Moss. And Willie Broughton make the tackle. Marinovich 1 for 6, 2 interceptions, and well, his passes, even at best, have very little on them. He's not known for arm strength. They feel he, for his years, he has a lot of savvy and moxie, and he has told us yesterday he's still learning. He should be a senior at Southern California. This could be a senior year. McMahon, a little fake, and then a handoff to Myers, and he was slowed up from behind by Willie Broughton, and then Lionel Washington finished the job, number 48.
That's as close to the Statue of Liberty play that the 90s will allow. You saw McMahon take the ball up like a throw and then hand it in front to Myers. Again, going with the trick stuff.
Anthony Smith, who leads the Raiders with 9 sacks, now comes in. Smith, who works with Los Angeles Youth. Doesn't like to talk about it, but is very generous in his time helping young people. And the final second ticks off, and there's the gun. End of the first quarter. A quarter of opportunity, but only 3 points for Philadelphia.
Silver summer. Silver time, silver line, girl in the silver suit, it looks so fine. Looks so fine. Silver bottom, silver top, silver fish, silver wish, come from here, right from here.
Silver moon,
and it tastes so good.
Capture the ones you love without missing out on the fun yourself with a Sony Handycam, America's most popular camcorder.
The Black & Decker Air Station. It has all the pressure you need to inflate anything fast. The Black & Decker Air Station, always at your service.
If your face was square, shaving would be simple, but your face has curves. Presenting the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the only twin-blade razor that flexes to follow the curves of your face. Schick Tracer, we're changing the face of shaving.
Monday, Oprah guest stars on Fresh Prince.
Your whole damn family is crazy.
Don't miss Oprah.
You got it, Oprah.
On an all-new Fresh Prince.
Fry, Oprah.
A hilarious NBC Monday.
Randall Cunningham, a star in this league, and they say I'm the man that's going to lead them to the Super Bowl. Why am I sitting where I am? And he said, he told us that he wants to go back to 90 when it was a more free-floating offense. He had more liberty and ad-libbing plays than last year. They were stricter with the offense because he was hurt. They designed it for McMahon and others, and now they're still using that offense. And obviously he's not comfortable in it, and he's really uncomfortable today. Third down as we open the second quarter. McMahon on the scramble, borrowing a page from Cunningham.
I believe he'll be short of the first down. Remember, on the slide, it's where the ball is when you go down, not where your waist is. And usually the ball is a couple of feet back of the slide.
Looks like Richie Kotite is going to go for it. And I was struck by Randall Cunningham was sitting on the bench there when his team is facing a critical third and seven. He's up on the sideline now, but the more that he's involved in what's going out there on the field, the better I think his teammates will feel about it.
Leading 3-0. It is fourth and one. So they bring in an extra tight end, Pat Beach. And now we'll call timeout. Now McMahon wants to come over and talk it over with Rich Kotite, a fighter, a boxer at the University of Miami.
It takes a special kind of car to pass the test we give at Oldsmobile. Like Cutlass Sierra, recently ranked the best model in initial quality in its price class by J.D. Power and Associates. What's more, of all the Cutlass Sierras sold in the last 10 years, 95% are still on the road. So if you're looking for a quality car, you know exactly where to look. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering. Visit your local dealer and get great deals on every model during Oldsmobile's 95th birthday celebration.
One of these engines was filled with Castrol Syntec, a new synthetic oil. The rest with conventional oils. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You see, Syntec's unique molecular structure bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it leaves a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Syntec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't.
Year-old Rich Kotite forsaking the field goal for fourth and one shot at Moore, leading only 3-0 early in the second quarter. Ball at the 21 of Los Angeles.
It's easy for Rich Kotite to do. With the defense that he has, you can go for it on fourth down. I mean, their defense is, on most weekends, not going to give that opponent many yards. Great luxury for Rich Kotite.
Raiders bolster the bulk, looking for something short. Bob Golic does come in this short yardage defense. Keith Sherman replaces Byers. It's Walker and Sherman. And Sherman for the first down at the 19. Dave Wehmer, veteran from the secondary, makes the tackle, and Kotite has four more downs.
Not a bad lead block by Herschel Walker, left-hand side of the screen, number 34. Good push up front. Boy, that's a helmet right in the chest of Winston Moss that really gave Heath Sherman just the yardage he needed for the first down to keep the drive alive.
The Eagles' second first down. The Raiders have three. Howie Long. And one of the theories around the league, and the Eagles talked about it too, is that Long is such a good man off the ball, so quick, and such a tough pass rusher, that the best answer is to run at Howie. But that doesn't always produce results either.
He has unbelievable strength, has always had great strength. You watch when they try to block him here, he just stands up that right guard and is there to make the tackle. Fundamentally, this guy may be, out of his stance, the best who has ever played the game.
Second down for McMahon. Boy, all day, someone's got to be open. Lionel Washington able to break up the attempt. Fred Barnett, oh, so close again to a touchdown.
I'm shocked at how much time he had. I mean, normally the Raiders rush and rush very well, but here's the guy who ends up getting the football down in the end zone at the bottom of the screen.
Telestrator not cooperating there.
But watch at the bottom of the screen. McMahon's looking, looking, looking. He was going to go to the swing, then finally, all the way across the field, incomplete.
Third and 11. McMahon, a good job of dancing away from pressure and then has to eat it at the 20-yard line as Greg Townsend makes the tackle. Will that be a sack? Yes, it will, and it'll be Townsend's first sack of the year. Here's a man with 13 last year who year after year has led the Raiders in sacks, 95 in 9 years, and finally gets number one this season.
Dick, the Raiders' coverage can't be that good. I mean, McMahon is finding no one open.
By the way, in the Miami lead, you saw Keith Jackson, a touchdown pass from Marino. Fake! Fegels! Incomplete! Intended for an offensive lineman, Brian Baldinger, who was an eligible receiver. A flag is down. Personal foul against the Raiders. Oh, oh my! So Archell's Raiders, defensively, a bright spot for the men in the silver and black. But after stopping the Eagles, a personal foul will carry with it an automatic first down.
No.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness, number 56. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
That's Andre Bruce, and it's because it's a shot to the head. So the Eagles certainly have helped the Raiders here by extending the drive, giving them a first down. And on the Eagles' sideline, no offense, zero offense. Where is Herschel Walker?
Yeah, they're not, that does not carrying an automatic first down. At least as yet, they have still have fourth down up on the yardstick, but the personal foul should be automatic.
Absolutely. They're going to change the down marker.
Yeah, the penalty yardage on fourth and 11 would be 15, or half the distance in this case.
But isn't that something, they have to resort to a fake field goal? We're seeing a lot of junk here by the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, at some point, head coach has to display confidence in his offense. Hammer that line of scrimmage.
On the last play, unnecessary roughness, number 56. Previous spot was the 20-yard line. Half the distance to the goal puts it at the 10. First down.
So the full 10 yards to go for the touchdown. The Eagles have started roaring out of the gate and then just having trouble collecting any points here the last four games. That's why McMahon's in there. Leading 3-0. Got a second chance. Herschel Walker powers for 3 or 4. Walker leading the Eagles and the sixth leading rusher in the National Football League with 619 yards starting today, plus 18 catches.
I think what the Eagles have done with Herschel Walker is limit where he's going to run. Don't bounce him to the outside. Keep him straight ahead. And at 230 pounds, still a force to bring down.
Heisman winner the year after Marcus Allen won that high honor. You'll see that on NBC again this year. Second and 6. Walker. Look at him plow his way to the 1 yard line on second effort. That's why it made you curious, yes. Bob Trumpy, that they weren't calling Walker's plays more often.
And Dick, there's so much to the psychology of the game of football where you can turn your offensive line loose and hammer this defensive line. It gives them confidence. It makes them feel like, hey, we can do something. When you run the junk and try to go to the outside, your offensive line never gets a chance to leave an impression on that defense.
Walker at 225 ran right through Aaron Wallace's attempt, and Wallace is 15 pounds heavier at the 5-yard line, takes it to the 1. 10th play of the drive, helped out by the personal foul on the 4th down fake punt. Walker again, touchdown!
just mentioned they're running Herschel Walker tackle to tackle. That's in the eighth spot. That's outside the tight end.
So the penalty by Andre Bruce cost Art Shell's team 6 and probably 7 points. It'll look like just 10 yards in the scoreboard, but it counts 7 for the Eagles, and they now lead 10 to nothing.
Going to be coming right at you. Watch 33 Eddie Anderson appear. Watch where he goes. Down to the ankles of Herschel Walker. Walker runs right through the tackle for the score.
Can a razor cut your beard below the skin without the blades touching your face? It can if it's a Norelco. Because inside the floating heads, our lift and cut system lifts the hair so when it's cut, it can drop below skin level without the blades touching your face. Are you shaving this incredibly close and comfortable? You are when you shave with Norelco. Norelco, we make close comfortable.
We built this business.
I hit the brakes. You know they're anti-lock brakes.
It was close, but we stopped in time.
Build this business.
Every year they plant new trees. Dad says they make good things from trees.
After my accident, they advanced my insurance benefits and built me a ramp and got me back on my feet.
We built this business to build your dreams.
When you compare Bravada's Smart Track to Explorer's four-wheel drive, it's easy to see who's in control of the situation and who's slipping up. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering. Up a steep grade, under slippery conditions, the Oldsmobile Bravada can beat the Ford Explorer. Even with one boat tied behind its back. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering. By Delta Airlines. At Delta, we love to fly, and it shows. By Norelco patented lift and cut shavers. We make clothes comfortable. And by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft and Miller Genuine Draft Lite, taking the country by storm.
The Eagles, after the interception by Hopkins, go 31 yards. It took him 10 plays plus a 10-yard penalty. But Walker finally scores, and it's 10-0. Can't fault the Raider defense. He can fault Bruce with a penalty. Bruce's kick high to Alexander Wright. The Eagles never let him get to full speed, and that's part of the design. The tackle made by Mike Flores at the 22-yard line. A reminder, the second half of NBC's doubleheader. Most of you will see the 6-2 Steelers against the 6-2 Buffalo Bills. The Steelers tied with the Eagles, least points allowed this year. The Bills, the top scoring AFC team. Other than you, will see San Diego and Kansas City or the Jets and Broncos. Raiders looking for a win today that'll bring them back into the flow of AFC West that kind of sort out the team to beat. Tim Brown from Redovich tackled after a gain of 13 by John Booty, the former Jet.
If there is an Achilles heel of this Philadelphia Eagles defense, it is John Booty. Not that he's a bad player, but he doesn't come close to the guy who was playing there last year, Ben Smith. This is a very aggressive defense. Booty gave Tim Brown too much yardage there, too much of a cushion. Teams try to find where Booty is, and that's the receiver that gets the ball against Philadelphia.
Brown out to the right against Booty on first down. To the other side. Oh, just did get it to Alexander Wright as diving in front of the play. It appeared to be Eric Allen, and a linebacker came shooting in there as well. Maybe it was William Thomas that had designs on an intercept. Let's check it.
He's not tricking him. You see Thomas jump up, almost get it. Eric Allen does make the tackle. It's a nice 6 or 8 yard gain. I think what they're doing here is trying to go to the five-step drop for Marinovich, keep the pass rush off of him, which is probably very sound on Archell's part.
10-0 Eagles, although both defenses have basically smothered the opponent's tries. Second and four. Popovich. And a flag goes down. Booty pushing on Tim Brown. Brown did not have access to the root of the ball. Booty had him pushed away.
Did you think that ball was catchable?
Well, that's
pass interference. Number 42 on the defense. First down at the spot.
That is another issue.
Yeah, Dick, I actually think the Raiders are very lucky here because as you see Booty force Tim Brown to the outside. Well, there certainly is contact. There's no question about that.
And Brown acted out the role well, and it's worth 11 yards to the Raiders, and the first time they've been in Eagle territory at the 46. Again, Brown and Booty matched up top of your screen. Play action. Redovich down the middle. Oh, missed, intercepted by Hopkins again. He knew he could have caught that one. Alexander Wright was the closest Raider.
Crossing pattern run by Alexander Wright. Young man with great speed, but Marinovich has to throw this over a defender. You see Byron Evans, 56, just gets in his way. Hopkins almost comes up with his second of the first half here today against Mr. Marinovich.
And the third against Marinovich. He was 3 for 9, as you can see. Green Bay leading the Giants. That's who the Eagles will play next week in Wisconsin. Marinovich going long for Brown. Intercepted by Booty at the 5-yard line. 3 picks by the Eagles. Marinovich does not look good this first half.
No, and Dick, there's no reason for him to throw this other than to just make a point. Sometimes the Raiders throw the ball deep for that what's referred to as vertical stretch. Threaten them with speed. But you can see the cornerback Booty is back here along with the safety. And the ball eventually does come down. And it's zone coverage. Wes Hopkins is back there. A very poor choice by Todd Marinovich. Look at the coverage. You can't just throw for impression. It doesn't work in this game anymore.
Fairness to Marinovich, the first interception really was a ball should have been caught by Willie Gault, went off his hands to the Eagles, but the next two were right to Philadelphia, and there have been a couple others that were almost intercepted. McMahon takes over and screens territory deep in his own end at the 5. Walker for 3 on first down. And the way that tackle was made, you've got to think Ronnie Lott, number 42, was in there somewhere. I didn't see a number, but it just sounded like, yep, there he is.
He does approach the line of scrimmage with what we would refer to as a blur.
He is the most fascinating interview I think we've had all year. We talked to a lot of players. He is so cerebral, articulate. This man has head coach crime. I asked him, would you like to coach? I think he could be a terrific head coach. Certainly we need more black head coaches in the NFL.
He's almost coaching some of these young guys on the Raiders now, Dick.
Walker trying to find room. There is none. Ricky Ellison makes the stop. And as expected, these two teams very physical. This won't be the last time. A little extra action after the whistle. Heller and Maurice Johnson of the Eagles defending their rights. He brings more than example of play, and I think it's the quality of the man and this veteran that he doesn't just perform by example.
Well, you're absolutely correct, and we've had the Raiders several times this season, and every young guy on this Raider team you talk to, you say, we have a problem? Yeah, you go to Ronnie Lott. He's counseled Marinovich. He's counseled Nick Bell. He's counseled this guy. He's counseled that guy.
Not just talks to him, but in practice says, hey, you're not running hard enough.
Run harder.
And yells at his teammates.
You can't have enough guys like that on your football team. I mean, what they do is so mystical and so magical, but it's so simple.
He said, I'm going to be like Jack Reynolds. They're going to carry me out of this game kicking and screaming. I'm going to enjoy every last hit. Third down, 6. Shotgun McMahon. Sikahema incomplete. And the Eagles will have to punt.
Well, makes you wonder, where is Randall Cunningham? They asked Richie Kotite, what if Jim McMahon has a great game? They didn't ask, what if Jim McMahon has a poor first half?
Well, he told Cunningham to be ready, and the promise has been there, and you heard on NFL Live, Cunningham said, but Cunningham, the promise I'd play in the fourth quarter of Dallas, and it didn't happen, so now I wonder if I really will start at Green Bay next week. Bigles, very high. Tim Brown takes a chance. He knew two Eagles were on top of him, Britt Hager and William Thomas. Time up.
We chose AT&T because our 800 service is our front door. If it shuts down, we shut down. To us, a single 800 call could be worth thousands of dollars. If a customer dials our 800 number and can't get through, it's like telling them to take their business somewhere else. When you have competition like I do, you better be there for your customers.
Only Delta gives you more flights from over here to over there. Only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities from over here to over there. In fact, only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities in Europe than all these airlines combined. Delta, we love to fly, and it shows the world over.
The folks in Lake Edna want to know the secret of new improved KFC Extra Tasty Crispy. How chicken so crispy outside could be so tender and juicy inside. The secret is a special KFC process called Double Ready, which is only the best chicken and dipping and uniquely not once, but twice, leaving the inside tender and juicy and the outside crispy and crunchy. Any questions?
Mm-mm. Hurry and try new improved Extra Tasty Crispy from KFC.
Next Saturday, Notre Dame's home slate concludes in grand style as the Penn State Nittany Lions, led by O.J. McDuffie and Richie Anderson, roar into South Bend to take on Rick Meyer, Reggie Brooks, and the Fighting Irish in a battle of two of the nation's highest scoring teams. Notre Dame football is home on NBC.
Back at Veterans Stadium, and the week of the quarterback, new quarterback, Todd Marinovich, is benched by Art Schell. Here's Jay Schrader. He hasn't started since the second game of the season when he threw for 380 yards against Cincinnati. Best ever by a Raider quarterback on the road, and was benched. But Marinovich didn't have it, so the veteran Schrader, and he comes out throwing strikes, a bullet to Tim Brown, and a first down at the 36. The other thing, Schrader inherited the best Raider field position, starting a series in the half by some 28 yards.
That definitely helps from behind the defense. You mentioned it. It's the zip on the football. Schrader with a very strong arm. Again, it's Tim Brown on 42, John Booty. Now the defense is going to have to roll to Booty to protect him. I suppose it's sunk in yet that young Todd is not on the field for our surfer.
Well, he knew he wasn't playing well, and that seemed apparent to everyone. Raider trying to rally the Raiders, and Dickerson caught for a loss in the backfield, but able to break free from rookie Tommy Jeter, third round pick from Texas, and picks up some yardage. Jay Schrader, and he knows if anyone could identify with Cunningham and what he went through this week, it's Schrader. He's been through that at Washington and now with the Raiders.
And we had the game after he was benched out in Los Angeles, and he said, hey, what can I do? I had my best game as a Los Angeles Raider. They put me on the bench. I mean, what more can I do? We lost. The quarterback has got to help this team win.
Second and eight. Schrader slips, but then able to slip a tackle, then goes out of bounds on the scramble inside the 30. It'll be short of the first down. Gain of six. William Thomas running him out.
Schrader is a guy who, when he was acquired from the Washington Redskins, this kid has a great winning percentage as a starter and as a quarterback in the NFL. When the Los Angeles Raiders acquired him, they thought he's the guy. But this guy has not played a whole bunch of football in his life. I mean, he's a former baseball player.
Yeah, 4 years out of UCLA.
Absolutely.
He was in the Toronto Blue Jay organization. He thought he might be celebrating a World Series. He was a teammate of Jimmy Key and Pat Ford and some of those Blue Jays. Third and three, and big hole for Marcus Allen.
And the all-time Raider rusher, Marcus Allen, has a first down inside the Eagle 10. 20 yards on the play.
How can you keep this guy out of the lineup? There is not as much blocking available as should result in 20 yards, but he can still make the moves. I asked him before the game, I said, what are they doing to you? And he said, they're torturing me. And I said, what does it tell you? And he says, it tells me that I won't be here next year, but I know I can still play.
Well, he was hoping that he'd be traded earlier this year. The Raiders said no one really wanted to pick up his big contract, but Marcus told me that he heard otherwise, that there were some teams that wanted him, but Raiders elected to keep him. To the 5-yard line goes Steve Smith. So what an interesting turn here. Schrader comes in for Marinovich, the veteran quarterback for the younger quarterback, and then Marcus Allen, a man basically in his feelings, has been benched because he's not going to be used except in special situations, but then he contributes every time he's allowed the opportunity. So
when you mention special situations, you got to recognize his talent. He has 20-yard runs, 15-yard catches, touchdowns from 5 or 6 yards, great blocks. Get him in the game.
He's on the sidelines on second and goal.
Coverage by Philadelphia. Initial receiver, the primary one, was Steve Smith. Then as Schrader rolls to tight end, Glover does an excellent job. Got 1 foot down.
Didn't drag the feet.
Got to drag the feet. Former basketball player. Part of learning the game is where that sideline exists without looking at it. But he did the good thing is that when the quarterback runs right, you run right with it, so he can hit you on the move.
But that one little scramble by Schrader told the big difference between the veteran and Marinovich.
Absolutely.
Because Schrader had a couple of chances to throw into coverage and didn't. Timeout going to be called by Los Angeles. So with third and goal at the 5-yard line, we take a break. 10-0 Eagles, 5 minutes to go in the half.
Vehicle from GM has no moving parts. It uses no gas. It's made entirely of plastic that turns into steel. The new GM MasterCard. Every time you use it, GM will credit 5% of your purchase toward a new car or truck from GM. That could mean hundreds, even thousands of dollars in savings over and above any other discounts or rebates. And there's no annual fee. The GM card, the new financial vehicle.
Discovered its real draft taste? The world is a very cool place.
The Houston Oilers looking to stay in the hunt in the AFC Central. The Minnesota Vikings, led by rookie head coach Dennis Green and a dominating defense, they're in first place in the NFC Central. It'll be mayhem in the Metrodome when these two interconference powers collide next Sunday.
Hall of Famer Art Schell, so many times in goal-to-goal situations, it was his block along with Upshaw on the left side that led the Raiders score. Marcus Allen is the long running back. He has 97 career touchdowns. Third and goal, Schrader. Incomplete to Alexander Wright. Tough chance. Schrader under some pressure as Clyde Simmons was breezing through. So the field goal unit comes on.
Now, Tom Walsh, the Raiders offensive coordinator, told us last night, first thing you have to do when you play a team like the Philadelphia Eagles is think protection. And that time, Marcus Allen was in there for protection. There's Tom Walsh standing up with a headset on. Mike White down in front of him. He's the quarterback coach.
23-yard attempt by Jeff Jaeger, who had a tremendous year last year. Missed only 5 of 34, but this year, 10 of 18, make it 11 of 19. And the Raiders have scored, so the insertion of Schrader into the lineup brings immediate results. Not what Archell had hoped for, the full 7, but the Raiders back in the game with a 4:56 to go in the half.
And that's a veteran. Schrader goes right to the kid, Todd Marinovich. Said, hey, you know, we got better field position. Thanks for your support. Marcus Allen with a 20-yard run. Nice completion to Tim Brown. And a little life in the Los Angeles Raiders offense here. But the same pattern is emerging for the Philadelphia Eagles. Defense on the field a lot. Missed opportunities by the offense. And with all of the great field position by Philadelphia, they only lead by 3.
Let me ask you, now I'm going to make you the Eagles head coach for about 2 seconds, and that'll please Philadelphia fans. Would you have benched Cunningham?
Yes, I would have. This was not just last week's performance. Over the last 2 or 3 weeks, his numbers had gone down. It was very obvious. And one of the biggest secrets on a football team is who's doing well and who's not. The secret is out amongst his teammates. They were willing to tell us publicly that Randall Cunningham was not as dedicated to the game plan, to watching film, as Jim McMahon was. That's the worst secret, the closest hell secret that an NFL football team can have. So Rich Cunningham, Kotak, made the absolutely the only choice he could make.
It's a wake-up call for Cunningham.
Absolutely.
Maybe a real blessing for him. Sikahema.
Born in Tonga, always a great return man. What an effort, and he's out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Seven-year veteran Sikahema from BYU. He just is so tough to bring down. Former Golden Glove champion, the 13-year-old.
Well, again now, Philadelphia with outstanding field position. Well, is this a repeat performance? Sikahema contributing any way he can.
40-yard return. They picked him up on plan B from Green Bay after his 5 years with the Cardinals. Fake to Walker. Howie Long pressuring. Heath Sherman gets the little checkoff pass in the flat to the 48 of the Raiders.
Now, where's Keith Byers? Now, this is a nice little play-action fake. It looked like the initial receiver was going to be Barnett. He's down the field on the right. You see him open, but when McManus flushed, he's got to find the outlet receiver. Excellent job done by that running back. There's Jay Schrader on the sideline celebrating that 3 points. Todd Marinovich in front. Oh, man. Not the way I hoped it started.
First quarterback to feel punished against this Eagle team. Not a very good fake, almost a broken play. No, it goes to Calvin Williams, and he has a first down at the Raider 42. That didn't look very smooth,
oh,
did it?
Sure didn't. Randall Cunningham on the sideline, and frankly, I'm not sure if that's the way. Well, let's see if we can pick it up. From behind the offense, we should be able to tell. No, it's a play-action fake, but again, Howie Long is just eating up Anton Davis, 78, and he's blowing up the initial part of the play to the point where the quarterback can't set up, which is what Randall Cunningham told us. I got no chance to set up.
He's like one of those kitchen little gadgets, of dicers. I mean, he just mixes everything up, cuts it all up, and hard to be smooth when that guy's breathing down your neck. Now it's Herschel Walker right at Howie Long. Long, basically, for you longtime fans of the Raiders, you usually saw Howie Long out on that left end, defensive end position. In the what's happened now, he's moved inside. He's taken Golic spot, basically.
I told you earlier, fundamentally, one of the soundest defensive ends to have ever played the game. What Howie has always done, and I think Earl Liggett taught him this, the defensive line coach, he has his knees, hips, and shoulders in line. So he's one of the most powerful guys in the first step or step and a half on the line, off the line, that the NFL has ever seen. Look at that beautiful stance.
And so lightning quick off the ball. The catch by Fred Barnett, who leads the Eagles coming in with 36. Lionel Washington, the tackle, first down.
Good time for Jim McMahon to throw. It's the most important thing. Barnett with bump and run coverage. Lionel Washington, little square in. Ball's on the way. Almost unstoppable. And again, back to Howie Long. Now, I told you his stance. Look at the power he produces. Throws Eric Floyd, 300 pounds, literally out of his way.
And his teammate Wallace also. 10-3 Eagles. First down, Philadelphia at the 27 of the Raiders.
Reverse.
Calvin Williams, the Raiders were waiting for that one. They'd seen that before. He's tackled way back at the 41-yard line by Andre Bruce. 14-yard loss as we come to the two-minute timeout.
Oldsmobile presents You Make the Call. With less than 2 minutes to go in the first half, Browning Nagel is sacked in the end zone and fumbles. Teammate Freeman McNeil recovers the ball and advances it to the 11-yard line. Now you make the call. Where do you spot the ball?
July 1992, Oldsmobile redefines quality. The Oldsmobile Achieva went head-to-head against Honda Accord and Toyota Camry. In a 100,000-mile real-world test, the independent test results prove Achieva beat them both with lower total cost, which consists of maintenance, repair, and operating costs. Quality has been redefined by Achieva and the company that went far enough to prove it. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
What call did you make? With less than 2 minutes to go in the half, a fumble can only be advanced by the player who fumbled. This is a safety. Spot the ball on the 20 for a free kick.
When your sinuses are closing in on you, what you need is a sinus spray like Sinex. Only Sinex adds Vicks Vapors to its decongestant, so at last you can feel your sinuses open up. For sinus, think Sinex.
The affordable Canon CJ10. The power of color is yours.
Get the power!
Back in Philadelphia, Dick Enberg with Bob Trumpy, inviting you to stay tuned. Halftime, the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report with Messrs. Costas Simpson and Coach Ryan. This is his kind of game. 69 total yards for the Eagles, and there's Randall Cunningham. And one of the comments I said... You know, in troubled times, you call friends. Whom did you call this past week? He said, I called Buddy Ryan several times. His line was either busy or he wasn't home. So, Buddy, next time pick it up. Randall needs to talk to you. He still has great affection for the former coach of the Eagles.
As do most Philadelphia Eagle players.
At last, reverse cost Eagles 15 yards officially. So, second and 25 for McMahon, who goes long. Magnificent throw by McMahon on the money to Fred Barnett for his fifth touchdown reception of the season.
And Cunningham is the first one to greet fellow quarterback Jim McMahon on the sideline. Touch of class, Randall.
69 yards total offense in the half, and they get 42 on that play. A big Eagle touchdown. With 1:53 left in the half, Ruzek to try the point. ...17-3 Philadelphia, as Jim McMahon applauding the rest of his linemen who come off, a flag down on the extra point. Tom White will clarify. Meanwhile, just a... You couldn't find two quarterbacks that are any more different.
There is no infraction on the play. He was blocked into the kicker. No infraction. Extra point is good.
I think we'll get back to your comment, but look, the absence of Keith Jackson forces this kind of coverage by the Raiders. Corners up, safeties out. The linebackers cover the inside guys, but with no Keith Jackson, there's really no threat down the middle. But still, Eddie Anderson, number 33, you'll see him deep here, allows the receiver to get by him. He bites on the little in move. McMahon stays with the play and makes the completion. You design this defense, Dick, for one reason, to shut down the outside receivers deep. Now, that's not the cornerback's fault, but Eddie Anderson bit on the move. McMahon stays with the play.
That just explain how really difficult this game, and this is the artistry. The timing had to be immaculate. The fake was perfect, and you beat a man by a step, and you get 7 points.
Yeah, this is also, I think, the experience of a Jim McMahon, hanging with the play, having great confidence in his receiver, looking at the safety, not at the corner, keeping him off and having him deep and making the completion.
And look who come to McMahon. Those are his friends, not the wide receivers, not the so-called skill players. McMahon drives a team at quarterback with the spirit of an offensive
lineman.
And when you ask about his best friends with the Bears, he starts rattling off his offensive line. Walter Payton, too, but it's the Hilgenberg.
Van Horn, Hilgenberg. He's the dominoes. He's the dominoes champion of the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, outside the NFL, that means nothing. But inside the NFL, I mean, that speaks volumes. Look at the offensive lineman. What's Sikahema doing there? Get him out of there. Sikahema doesn't belong.
Well, he plays like one.
He's trying to fit in.
Randall Cunningham, his thoughts seem elsewhere. Seventeen to three. 1:53 left in that. Very short kick. McCallum. Fair catch that one. Stays on his feet. And brings it out to the 40-yard line. And with plenty of time, Jay Schrader brings his offense back on the field. And next Saturday, boy, they must be in a pleasant mood at Notre Dame. Well, first of all, let's talk about Hoop It Up next Saturday. That'll follow Notre Dame football. It's the world's largest basketball tournament and spotlights the nation's best street players, challenging Dr. J's team of greats, Gervin and Cooper and Calvin Murphy and Walter Davis, on the court of dreams.
Those street legends. And oh, they're dangerous in basketball.
That's a double bill next Saturday following Notre Dame and Penn State. Oh, Notre Dame, I can't believe. I thought Boston College would give them a real go. Marcus Allen greeted with a flag down. Byron Evans making the stop.
What did Byron Evans tell us? He said, when Marcus Allen was a rookie, he toasted me up. Toasted me up, translated means, and beat me like a drum. And Marcus Allen is even laughing. Byron Evans probably referring back to his rookie year when Marcus Allen made him look bad. That was a picture-perfect tackle.
Illegal formation. Not on the line of scrimmage. 5 yards, previous spot. Still first down.
Ball marked back to the 35-yard line. You're just joining us. And somehow missed the controversy here in Philadelphia. It's Randall Cunningham sitting down for a week and McMahon running the show. And then Todd Marinovich benched by Art Schell today. As Marinovich intercepted three times in the first half. And veteran Jay Schrader dumping it off to Marcus Allen. Oh, what a move by Allen on Eric Allen. Not related, although both grew up in San Diego, California. 14 yards on the play.
Actually, very heady move by Jay Schrader. Avoiding the rush from around the outside, steps up, still makes the completion.
Just shy of the first down. It was first and 15, now second and a short two.
Sort of available.
Raiders with two timeouts left and a minute 32 to go. Officially second and one, closer to second and two. The 50-yard line, they may have to measure on this one.
Well, the insertion of Schrader, all things considered, has been a very timely move by Art Schell. Terry Robiski on the sideline there with Art Schell signaling in the plays. They're called by Tom Walsh up there. Raiders performed very admirably here in this first half.
First down, clock running.
Center of that sandwich. They can break quarterbacks in pieces between those two guys.
Reggie White, who has more sacks than games played, the only one in the NFL.
Reggie McElroy, man on man with Reggie White. That is a mismatch. He even tried to get Todd Pete 64 out there. He beats them both.
41, 40 seconds left. Raiders don't spend a timeout, second and long. Marcus Allen staying in the block. That's Tim Brown. And he was dropped down with a flag down. That's a first down. Booty finally gets Tim Brown to the turf. And we'll see if this is a face mask. Clock stopped, as you saw, 30 seconds left in the half, 17-3 Philadelphia. The ball at the 37 if it counts.
Well, it certainly didn't take him long to find it. There was a face mask penalty there, but it's coming back. It looks like it's against the Raiders, Dick.
Well, apparently they did not see the face mask, but did catch one of the Raiders with a foul. Mark it back, Tom White. All
offensive win. Pass interference, number 88 offense, 10 yards from the previous spot, still second down.
Ethan Horton, the tight end, trying to pick off a defender to free up Brown, apparently.
Well, that has become so common in the game today, the tight end releasing off the line of scrimmage. There you see 88. Actually, he hits John Booty on the shoulder. That's very questionable, but the NFL officials have called that rather closely this year.
Was pretty good. Marcus Allen, now the Raiders with the penalties being pushed back and apparently want to just run out the clock. Seth Joyner makes that tackle. Joyner playing with a brace on a injured left knee. Highly regarded talent out of University of Texas El Paso and Pro Bowler last year.
One of the captains, he won't even go out and shake the other team's hand. He gets nasty on game day.
We saw him earlier with a number of his fallen friend Jerome Brown shaved in the back of his head. The end of the first half. Archell decision making, as does his counterpart Rich Kotite. The Eagles by two touchdowns.
What makes Los Angeles great is its people. They truly make it the city of angels. He's Ethan Horton of the Los Angeles Raiders, and he knows our community.
When we come together through the United Way, we can accomplish great things. It's there in the faces of these children in this United Way daycare program. Here they get professional care, healthy food, and guidance. Dr. Herbert Carter, president of the United Way of Los Angeles, makes the importance of the United Way clear to all of us.
Ethan, United Way, like the Los Angeles Raiders, is dedicated to excellence in performance. This year, 43% of our campaign results will go to support programs which focus on children and youth. We are committed to helping to build a more caring.
Then Michael J. Fox and James Woods are stuck with each other.
I'm sensing that you're not completely happy with this situation.
There's something a little different about our car.
You can't trust your partner, but can you trust?
The television premiere of The Hard Way after Secret Service, the movie, NBC tonight.
So many people attracted to the 93 Grand Prix? Could be because the Pontiac Grand Prix has standard air, automatic, and a fuel-injected V6. It could be the way the Grand Prix handles. It could be the low price, just $239 a month with a Pontiac Smart Buy. Or it could be that so many people are attracted to the Grand Prix because so many people are attracted to the Grand Prix. The 93 Grand Prix. Get yours now with a Pontiac Smart Buy for just $239 a month.
Lou Tilly Sports, tonight at 6.
A live halftime report, brought to you by Domino's. Nobody knows like Domino's how you like pizza at home.
Okay, the former Eagles coach Buddy Ryan is here, and of course, O.J. Simpson. We'll get their comments on the first half in just a moment, but first to the scoreboard. The game you folks are watching, the Eagles 17 and the Raiders 3. Elsewhere, Dallas goes to the half at the Silverdome with a 20-3 lead over the Lions. Let's take a look at the rushing comparison. Two of the game's best, Emmitt Smith and Barry Sanders, head-to-head here. Smith, 14 carries for 43 yards, but two of them for touchdowns. 87 yards in the first half for Barry Sanders. He has not had a particularly good season to this point, but he could be on his way to his third 100-yard rushing performance of the year. Miami up at Indianapolis 21-0. Highlights from that game. Ted Marchibroda, the Colts coach, was hoping to sweep the season series. They had upset the Dolphins at Joe Robbie a couple of weeks ago. It doesn't look like it's going to happen, though. Marino on the first possession for Miami rolls right, hits Keith Jackson for the 2-yard TD, 7-0. Next time they had the ball, Mark Higgs caps the drive, breaks tackles, and bulls his way in from 3 yards out, and it's 14-0. To make matters worse for Indianapolis, Steve Empman, the outstanding rookie defensive lineman, goes hobbling off, sprained his left knee, won't be back today. The exact extent of the injury, we don't know. And Miami trying to go to 7-2 up, 21-0 at the half. New Orleans and New England, it's the Saints trying to become 7-2 as well and looking to send New England to a record of 0-9, leading 21-7 at the half in Foxborough. Bobby Hebert has thrown 3 touchdown passes, 2 of them to Quinn Early. Cleveland and Houston, it's 10-0 in favor of the Browns. Halftime at the Astrodome. Let's take a quick look at some of what's going on there. And as you see, someone has made the long trip from the dog pound in Cleveland to the Astrodome, and something to bark about here. Tom Zach pumping, faking, and then finding Leroy Horde for the 46-yard touchdown. That put them up 10-0, combined with a 44-yard field goal by Matt Stover, and that's where they stand at the half. Minnesota could be 7-2 very shortly. Tampa Bay might lose their 5th in a row. They had a 3-1 start, but it looks like they're tumbling down here, losing 28-0 to the Vikings. They've just begun the third quarter. 2 of the 4 touchdowns for Minnesota have been defensive scores, one on a fumble return, the other on an interception. And the Giants, early in the third quarter at the Meadowlands, leading 13-7 over the Packers. Okay, Juice, let's talk about the first half at the Vet.
Well, we can't fault anything that Jim McMahon has done up to this point. He looks very comfortable in that offense, and they've scored 17 points. So that speaks for itself. I think the big question now is if this game continues the way it's going, what is Rich Kotite going to do next week? He's already promised that he's going to start Cunningham next week. Can you do that?
Well, I guess he can do anything he wants to. He's a coach.
Sure he can. I mean, he's made it pretty clear that he's looking to clear Cunningham's head from his perspective and give him a different and fresh view of the game, and he will start him next week no matter what McMahon does. That's what Kotite says.
Well, that's probably what he'll do then, you know. The young kid, though, from the Raiders, I think he should be playing on Saturday in college. You know, he's a senior in college, and instead he's at the Vet playing the toughest defense in the National Football League, having a terrible day, 3 turnovers. But I think Arshell is probably happy to go in at halftime only 17-3 with the field position and turnovers that the Raiders have had.
Yeah, Marinovich would be just a senior at USC had he stayed in, and a nightmare first half for him. As great as the Eagle defense is, no matter how their offense sputters, you can never count them out. They could get to the Super Bowl or deep into the playoffs, even if Cunningham doesn't click the rest of the way.
Well, Cunningham will click. He's a great talent. They just got to turn him loose and let him do his thing.
Do you have reservations about Cunningham in big games? In playoff games and some big regular season games he hasn't come through?
No, people, you know, the first time we went to the playoffs against the Bears, he had about 600 yards total offense. We didn't have any touchdowns, but they weren't his fault. The next 2 years we went, we were beat up and crippled up, especially in the offensive line, and he didn't have very much of a chance, really.
See, that game against the Bears was the one in the fog, right?
Well, we had a fog game, yeah.
I forgot about that because I couldn't see any of it. It was like the game was played in Transylvania. We got to take a commercial break here. When we come back, Gail Gardner will join us for a look at the upcoming Steelers-Bills game from a slightly different perspective, and we'll do it after this from your local stations.
The Oprah guest stars on Fresh Prince.
Your whole damn family is crazy.
Don't miss Oprah.
You got it, Oprah.
On an all-new Fresh Prince.
Oprah, Oprah.
Hilarious NBC Monday. Wednesday, Seinfeld's new love has a mysterious secret.
She's a virgin. She just told me.
Well, I didn't know.
Well, it's not like spotting a toupee.
Then the newlyweds meet the tenant from hell. And it's Kramer?
Hey, what happened to that Jerry guy who's living? He's writing a sitcom for NBC. Good luck to him.
Kramer on Seinfeld and Mad About You, all new NBC Wednesday.
I remember the last reunion, driving the old beater from college. But now, a gorgeous new 93 Taurus. Life is good.
Quality plus savings, a quality plus deal. Win with a leader right now.
I shouldn't get so hung up on appearances, but how do you show off dual-side airbags? Fall in love with the 93 Taurus at your Quality Plus 4 dealer. Right now!
All the day's highlights and scores, Sunday Sports Wrap, tonight at 11:30. This is the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's. Nobody knows like Domino's how you like pizza at home.
Well, later on today, it's the Steelers and the Bills. The game most of you will see is the second part of the NBC doubleheader. Now, we've talked about this game from a strategic standpoint, but Gail Gardner's got a different angle.
Different angle, a very, very personal angle, I would say. The town of East Brady, Pennsylvania, has a real dilemma today. After all, this is diehard Steeler territory, yet their hometown boy just happens to be one of the top quarterbacks in the NFL, but he's not a Steeler. Jim Kelly is one of six boys raised by a father who was an orphan himself and a spunky mother who has had to deal with emphysema for the last 7 years. So when the Bills take the field at home against the Steelers today, it's a traumatic time for the town that brought us.
It was a town where there was no stoplights. At the time when I was going, the nearest mall was like 30 miles away. And you go into my town, you see a big sign welcoming people to East Brady home with Jim Kelly. I didn't expect that, but growing up in the Pittsburgh area, growing up watching the Steelers win those Super Bowls all the time, I always said maybe one of these days I can be put in that situation where, you know, my dream can come true and be an NFL quarterback, and then you never know.
Well, his dream did come true. Its roots nurtured in the backyard of the Kelly household, where Mom Alice would watch Dad Joe give their six boys the athletic insight and encouragement he never had as a child.
When Jim was a senior in high school, my brother and I, Kevin, were in 10th grade, and there's a lot of fun moments that year because it'd be Kelly passes to Kelly for a touchdown while Kelly was blocking, so that made it pretty interesting.
Jim's a person that takes charge. He was always that way in high school, and he is that way right now as I see him playing for the Buffalo Bills.
Everybody in this town here looked up to him, and they still do, and they follow his whole career, and it just makes me feel good that the people are behind him.
It's that career that's allowed Jim to provide so well for his family, something he does with great joy, especially for his mother.
I tell you what, she's the greatest lady in the world, and I love her so much. And just to see her face when I can do so many things for her, it makes it worthwhile.
One problem the family does have is that they are long-standing Steeler fans, except, of course, when Jim is the opponent.
I was watching a Steeler game on TV, and then I'd watch the ticker tape to see how Buffalo was doing. I was having hard for you. Buffalo wasn't doing anything. I was praying, please, God help Jim. Come on, God help the Steelers. And when the Steelers won, I left out one, yoo-hoo! I think the whole neighborhood heard me. Now, this week's going to be different. I don't want the Steelers to do that to us again.
Jim, Steeler fans will be sitting and watching this game today very intently. What do you think they'll be thinking?
In the Pittsburgh area? Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's take the old East Brady Kelly's head off today. We want to win, but I know from the people that grew up in my hometown, this is a game that they've been waiting for ever since the schedule came out. This is one that they put the big circle around. It's one where, you know, people are not going to want to miss. They're not going to want to get away from their tube. They're going to stay tuned into this game.
Well, East Brady's about a three-hour drive from Buffalo, and the Bills people tell us that roughly 3,000 to 4,000 of the 80,000 at Rich Stadium today will be from the general Pittsburgh area.
Okay, Jim himself has had to provide 100 tickets for people, so right away you know there's a lot going on there and very, very exciting game for the whole family.
And he's happy he's staying at the Bills Hotel, even though it's a home game, because his friends and family
people
are swarming all over his house.
Too many people around, yeah.
All right, time for us to clear out of here for a while, and NFL Live halftime activities we'll continue. Thank you, Gail.
Ready for the second half at Veterans Stadium with the Eagles leading 17-3. Look at the statistics in just a moment, the first half, and I think they'll reveal, obviously, that the defense has dominated. The score is a bit misleading.
Yeah, the three turnovers by the Los Angeles Raiders, the great field position by the Philadelphia Eagles, have really produced a 17-3 score. Actually, the Eagles should be ahead by a lot more. Raiders have struggled except for the one drive with Jace Rader at quarterback. The penalty certainly helped the Philadelphia Eagles to get the ball in the end zone, but the sum total of the turnovers in the field position have produced this kind of score, Dick.
Jager picks it off and hits it hard and high. Sikahema will take it out. Always a threat, and he is drilled at the 24-yard line. Tackled by Napoleon McCallum, and let's look at the Keystone Coors halftime statistics. As you see, 21 yards rushing for a team that's averaging 142 a game through the first eight, and the total yards almost even, and the three turnovers, as Buddy Ryan pointed out at halftime. 17-3 doesn't sound very good if you're a Raider fan, but not bad considering all the opportunities.
And the field position, they are very fortunate to be just down by 14.
Side out by giving to Keith Byers, who was the quiet man in the first half and did not play much. Ricky Ellison, who loves to fill the hole from that middle linebacker position, makes the stop for the Raiders.
Dick, the point I think I would have to make about the Philadelphia Eagles offense in the first half, where you see the field position and what a part it's played in the game, is that the Eagles have really gone with a lot of junk. Motion and reverses and fake reverses and fake draws. All of that plays into the comments made by Randall Cunningham. That's Zeke Kratkowski on the sideline. This is a more complicated offense. I want to go back to the one I ran 2 years ago.
Play action. By Eddie Anderson out of the hands of Calvin Wimmer from Barnett, and then Anderson, as they came to the turf, stole it away. So the Raiders have their first turnover. Barnett with the catch for a moment, and then watch 33 Anderson.
He does make the catch, and then it bounces off his helmet, and Eddie Anderson uses Barnett as kind of a cushion and puts it right back in his chest, and the Raiders have the football.
Long throw by McMahon serves almost as a punt, but the Raiders pleased to have it at the 35 so quickly here in the second half. McMahon made a good throw.
Yes, he did. Although, again, double coverage. Safety and corner back there. Tough to make those completions, but they did score a touchdown on that coverage.
Thanks to Dickerson. Schrader starts the second half and throws one up for grabs. Oh, my. Eric Allen makes his second interception today. And then hit from behind by Alexander Wright at the 45 of the Raiders. Ethan Horton, the intended receiver, but that ball just floated up there. Horton had no chance.
Not even close, Dick. From behind the defense, play action fake, fools no one. See Horton right side of the screen. That ball gets away. Boy, Allen is waiting on the thing. He and Rich Miano, 38, were fighting over that interception. Oh, again, the turnover, fourth of the day against the Raiders, and they have great field position once again.
From the 45. Herschel Walker gets away from Howie Long. Whoa, what an open field tackle by cornerback Terry McDaniel.
Oh.
180 pounds, and he attacked Walker.
Coaches encourage players on blocking and tackling to go to and through the man. Well, Terry McDaniel certainly got that message on this particular tackle. Watch him go by Herschel Walker to knock his legs out from underneath him.
No gain. McDaniel, much like Eric Allen of the Eagles, so good that you don't hear much about him because teams operate away from his side of the field. And close to a first down. Third and one.
Nick, again, the Los Angeles Raiders staying with the double rotation zone. McDaniel up. You got the safety right behind him. You'll see him come into the play. Eddie Anderson. They're doubling the outside, and that's the absence of Keith Jackson. No threat down the middle. I mean, you're not going to pay the same attention to Maurice Johnson and Pat Beach that you had to play to Keith Jackson. And these guys are getting double teamed on every snap down the field.
And that's frustrated them. Cunningham isn't the only one who's been upset. Barnett said, how can they let the best NFL tight end get out of here? Byers met by Winston Moss. I don't think he got the first down on third and one.
But again, the luxury for Rich Kotite with his defense, you can go for it here.
Leading by two touchdowns, 17-3. Kotite will go for it. He tried a fake field goal, remember, in the first half. That did not work, except that Andre Bruce of the Raiders committed a personal foul that gave the Eagles an extra four downs, and they eventually scored to take a 10-0 lead. Beach and Johnson, two tight ends in. 10 seconds on the play clock. Keith Sherman and Herschel Walker behind McMahon. Sherman, second effort, might have. It's going to be close.
Very close.
Boy, you could hear that collision all the way to the press level.
It's unusual, I think, too, that the Philadelphia Eagles on short yardage plays, they've run the same play twice. Heath Sherman carries it. Herschel Walker lead block to the right side of the offense. Boy, this is going to be very close.
Only Sherman's second effort gave the Eagles this hope. He had been stopped right at the 35-yard line and then was able to twist away and gain that half yard. Is it enough for the first down? Yes.
Eagles certainly making it tough on themselves. I mean, none of this is coming easy, Dick, offensively for them.
And maybe this supports Randall Cunningham's argument that he wants to go back to the offense of 2 years ago.
Absolutely. He was telling us, look, when I ran, I had to run because I think I can run. McMahon is not known as a runner, but Randall made up for a lot of the inconsistencies in the offense with his athletic ability, running the ball.
McMahon, intercepted, and then dropped by Aaron Wallace. Had it for a moment, and then it trickled out of his hands. He was in perfect position. Well, Cunningham, you talk about running, and of course McMahon in his early days with the Bears was a good runner, but Cunningham's the third leading rusher in Eagle history.
Isn't that amazing? Had almost 1,000 yards rushing 2 years ago. Wallace, and oh, wait a minute, what's that? That ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage. Looked by Willie, Willie Broughton got his hand up there. Now Wallace might have had that one going the other way.
Broughton signed as a free agent, number 97, in front of Wallace, playing a lot today. Myers cutting back, juggling the ball as Howie Long makes the tackle.
And Broughton blew the play up. He made Keith Byers cut back into Howie Long, so it's an easy tackle. Long will go across the line, along the line of scrimmage here. Now Broughton pushes him back inside. There's 97. Easy tackle for Howie Long. Man, this has been a struggle offensively for the Eagles.
Well done, John Gonzalez, our director. John Ferretz is our producer, right on and play in a close-up fashion to appreciate that pinball game those 275 to 300 pounders play in the middle of that defense. Third down and nine. McMahon caught by Greg Townsend. Well, he had a taste of his first sack of the season in the first half. That's number two.
Oh, this is awful easy for Townsend. He's on Anton Davis, the offensive right tackle. Townsend with great speed. He gets that great first step. And he is up the field and up the field in a hurry and right in McMahon's face before he can even set up to look downfield. You see, McMahon just barely got his feet set there. Townsend right there. Again, great field position. Nothing out of the Eagle offense.
So Eric Allen's interception does not produce points, and Fiegels hits this one perhaps too good. And the Raiders will take it at the 20-yard line with it a timeout. 9:39 left in the third quarter.
Why did Hertz invent number one club goal service? To beat the rush hour. See, every plane and everybody seems to land at once. But with goal service, there's no stopping at the counters and no paperwork. Instead, you go nonstop to your waiting car with your name and lights. Only Hertz has number one club goal. The best reason yet why Hertz beats the rush hour. To Hertz, the rest of the day is a piece of cake.
Like an angel, talk like an angel. you are.
Just when you thought you knew everything about Volvo.
Devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in disguise.
Slowing down. That ain't you. No, no, that's not you. Easy drinking beer, that silver bullet smooth.
Know where it's coming from, setting the mood. The pure taste of the Rockies and silver bullet smooth.
Make the move, Coors Lights, silver bullet smooth.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Hertz No. 1 Club Gold. Hertz's fastest service, now in more locations coast to coast. By Coors Light, the silver bullet is the right beer now. By New Hager wrinkle-free cotton pants, 100% cotton, 0% wrinkles. And by Volvo. Volvo would like you to drive safely.
Greg Townsend, the last couple years, says he shaves his head 2 times a week. It takes some working to keep that dome sweaty and polished. He's got 2 sacks today, and that last sack was key. It took the Eagles out of a possible 50-yard field goal and forced the punt, and on the touchback, Los Angeles will put it in play at the 20-yard line, trailing 17-3. Raider possessions, 8, and 4 of them have ended with interceptions.
And they're still in the game if they get something going on this drive.
Against a very talented defense. Dickerson. A lot of work for 3 yards. Reggie White chased him down.
But that is a great advantage if you can get Eric Dickerson running sideways. Towards the sideline. We'll take 4 or 5 yards.
Check the other scores here on the midpoint of this NFL season. On 2nd and 6. Dropped by Ethan Horton. Tough catch, but it was there.
Well, again, pressure. Pressure constantly by this Eagle defense on Jay Schrader. Watch when he sets up bottom of the screen. 59 Seth Joyner, again Eric Dickerson. Huge mismatch. And it just flushes Schrader a little bit, makes him throw it a little quick. Pressure comes from everywhere on this Eagle defense.
And there's a testimony to the Eagles' pressure tactics. Schrader 2 for 6 passing. This is a 3rd and 6 play, and he goes deep downfield. No one there. Overshoots Tim Brown.
Well, they are insistent on that pattern. The matchup they're looking for, again, Tim Brown on John Booty. And there's help by Rich Miano, 38. There was decent pressure that time by the Eagles. Not a whole bunch, but another outstanding series by the Philadelphia defense. Boy, this is repetitive.
And remember, this is a defense without a starting cornerback of a year ago, Ben Smith, without Andre Waters, one of the renowned hitters in the NFL at safety, out with a broken leg. And a defense that's playing with one of their better men, Seth Joyner, with a knee brace. And they lose Jerome Brown, a defensive tackle. Buddy Ryan really put together some defensive thoroughbreds. Sitkahema, who saw his head snap back as he was belted, but gets to the 47. A 40-yard punt, 18 yards for Sitkahema. As you look at Reggie White and company, the defense has been the Philadelphia story today.
September 1957. Road and track on the Volvo 444. With a car like this, who needs a sports car? October 1992. History repeats itself.
Hello.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's very important to remember at a time like this, when it's very cold and you've got to get going. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
When regular drills hold you back, send in the Ranger Cordless Drill from Black & Decker. It goes anywhere to handle all the tough jobs. No strings attached. The Ranger Cordless Drill, a powerful gift idea from Black & Decker.
This Magnavox portable CD player with pure digital sound is the best thing to take on vacation. Unless you compare it with this clever Magnavox 5-inch TV. Great pictures
of course,
anywhere.
The
best is this compact yet intelligent Magnavox camcorder with autofocus. Unless you take this Magnavox 3-inch LCD TV, which connects to my camcorder so I can watch my vacation on the ride home. Looks as though I had a pretty good time.
The ingenious products from Magnavox. They're smart, very smart.
Another chance for Rich Kotite's Eagles, who start in Raider territory. 9 possessions in the game. Philadelphia has started 6 of those on the Raider half of the field.
And yet they only have 17 points. Absolutely remarkable.
Well, you got to give credit to the Raider defense, too. It's not just all the offense not working.
I agree with you, but Richie Kotite and his offense, they've established nothing today offensively. Zero.
So maybe it's more than the quarterback problem. McMahon. Wide open is Calvin Williams. An acrobatic catch and a punishing tackle at the 31-yard line from Terry McDaniel.
That was great concentration on the football. Slight play action holds Ricky Ellison, number 50. McMahon with a nice touch here. He knows he's going to get hit. First thing it hits is the back of his helmet. He jumps right up. It's the slot man running the corner underneath the zone coverage. Now, that play has worked. Can you think of another play that has consistently worked for Philadelphia today?
No, your points all taken. 4 catches, 49 yards for Williams.
To the tailback, give it to the fullback. Nebraska runs that play.
30 yards for the score. Heath Sherman's first touchdown romp of the season. And he hooks it through. It's 24-3. Why did it work?
Well, Eagles obviously give the ball to 34. Watch the arms go out like he's handing it to 34. The defense overruns the play. 50, Ricky Ellison overruns the play. The cutback, the missed tackle by Eddie Anderson, and Heath Sherman goes 46 yards for the score.
Liberty Mutual presents Legends of the Game. He was on the throwing end of the legendary alley-oop pass of the 50s. But while that was just a passing fancy, this quarterback was known for his fancy passing. A 2-time most valuable player, he threw for over 30,000 yards and 242 touchdowns. Who was this legend?
She was the paper's best writer. Now she can't finish a sentence without pain. She has a debilitating hand injury caused by repetitive motion. So Liberty Mutual is helping customers redesign their workstations to reduce the pain and lost work days. Because we don't want her to report a story like this ever again. At Liberty Mutual, we're facing the issues that face our customers.
Y.A. Tittle led the Giants to 3 consecutive title games while authoring a Hall of Fame career. A true legend of the game.
Now save 25% on selected Goodyear all-season radials for cars and light trucks. Save 25% on Invicta GS. Save 25% on Wrangler AT and HT. That's right, save 25%. Where? Goodyear. When? Now.
From Francis Ford Coppola,
Gary Oldman, Winona Ryder, Anthony Hopkins, Keanu Reeves, Bram Stoker's Dracula. Rated R at theaters Friday.
While the Eagles have lost three of their last four, they have not been defeated here at Veterans Stadium. So they're going for 5-0, and that's very important to Rich Kotite. He talked to us about that. In fact, if the Eagles could go through a season at home unbeaten, it'd be the first time since 1948 when they won the NFL championship.
1948? Well, you had a lot of time here today to be doing some work.
Steve Van Buren, Tommy Thompson, Pete Pihos, Greasy Neal. Alexander Wright, a speed burner. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line. William Frizzell, reactivated, reacquired by the Eagles, pushed him out.
Dick, from behind the offense, it's the pull, it's the tailback pitch, but watch what happens. Excellent blocking here. They get a double and rub on Ellison, and when the running back cuts back here, I mean, he's totally behind the defense. Watch 50. Ricky Ellison overruns Heath Sherman, missed tackle by Eddie Anderson. You saw Gunther Cunningham on the sideline talking to Ellison, talking to Eddie Anderson. Boy, that's a beautiful play.
The Eagles have opened it up with a 24-3 lead, and straight under pressure throws through a crowd. Seth Joyner had a hand on it.
Tim Brown did not look in the mood for that one.
Second half of our doubleheader. Stay with us. The Steelers and the Bills with 6-2 mark square off at Rich Stadium. San Diego back in the fight. 4-4 against the Chiefs, surprisingly, disappointingly for their fans, 4-4. And the Jets trying to feed off the win against Miami as they traveled a mile high against Denver. Denver, the leaders in the West. Schrader now 2-for-8 for only 30 yards. And he starts to scramble and then throws low and outside to Willie Gault.
Well, defenses can do a lot of things to you physically, and they show on the field. But what this defense does to you psychologically, I'm talking about the Eagles defense, just takes you out of the mood. I mean, the Raiders have had bad field position. They've given up the four turnovers. And Bud Carson on the sideline, I mean, this is a perfect game for the defense. He's finally getting some support from the offense. You mentioned earlier in the game that Carson thought these were the best coverage linebackers he'd ever coached until you brought up Jack Ham's name.
Well, he said as a group then. Ham, Lambert, Cole, or Russell was very good, but these three are the best I've ever coached. Underneath the right, breaks a tackle and has a first down out at the 49-yard line. Alexander Wright's first catch as a Raider. Make that his first today. He's got two.
I believe he's the player. He's the player, if I'm not mistaken, when we talked to Al Davis earlier this season. What do I need another wide receiver for? And 2 weeks later from the Dallas Cowboys, a former second-round draft choice. Oh, Alexander Wright shows up in a Raider uniform.
Finally being used today as that third wide receiver, has his first two catches in Los Angeles. So from the 49. Dickerson takes one step and then is devoured by Reggie White, with Seth Joyner picking up the scraps.
Say amen, brother. An ordained Baptist minister just shoving Reggie McElroy out of the way. Oops, no, you're not going here, son. This is as far as this particular journey goes. Actually, nice picture, arm not big enough.
Everything's so understated in the city of brotherly love.
This guy is a man.
Second down, 13. Nice throw. And it's Ethan Horton, the tight end, close to the yardsticks. It'll be a yard shy of a first down on a 13-yard pickup. Eric Allen, the cover man for the Eagles. And here comes Marcus on third down.
Now, that catch by Ethan Horton, I kind of thought coming into this game that Ethan Horton would be a busy guy. That's his first catch of the game. The reason I ask is against Dallas, the Cowboys threw the ball to Jay Novacek a lot in this underneath zone coverage of the Philadelphia Eagles, and they were successful. Horton, just his first catch of the day, I'm really surprised.
They could get a first down right now if they snapped the ball. Eagles had 12 in on the field, but Trader didn't notice it. Allen diving, he's got it at the 40-yard line.
Allen, now 32 years of age, needs three more touchdowns to hit the 100 mark. Dickerson needs five, and he'd be at five, at 100 as well.
The amazing thing about Marcus Allen, in my estimation, is if you polled all the Raiders that have been around the Raiders since Marcus Allen got there, I think most would say that Marcus Allen is an Al Davis-type player, and yet there is something amiss between the two. I do not, for the life of me, understand it.
Allen with 23 yards rushing. Dickerson in back of the game at 28.
Oh, that's a cut.
Well, they call it an incomplete pass as Schrader threw it right out of his own hand into the ground as Reggie will testify to the play. He was closest.
Well, they're going to call it an incomplete pass, but I don't know how you can't call this intentional grounding. You see the referee right there. Now, his idea is to protect the quarterback. He's not really watching the rest of the field, but when Jay gets away with one there, I mean, his arm is going for it. No question about that. He didn't want that thing to get loose.
Now, there was no intent there. It wasn't like he threw it right down at the feet of White. Now, Schrader, although he's been intercepted once, to Marinovich's three, his number is not very impressive. So Dickerson barely had time to catch that before William Thomas said hello. That'll bring up third and about five.
Every play we see the Raiders run, for the most part, when the ball gets to the receiver, there's at least one Philadelphia Eagle there, sometimes two, and very often three.
As White, the number 59, Seth Joyner, Buddy Ryan will be pleased to know that Seth Joyner still talks about Ryan. He says, this isn't a nice guy game. You're supposed to hit him and walk over him, not help him up. So we've got to be more intimidating. Wright has his third catch, but he'll be shy of a first down as Izell Jenkins, an extra defensive back, makes the stop. Good spot at the 31, but it'll leave the Raiders 1 yard shy of a first down. Brings up fourth.
I don't think Arch Hill has any choice in this situation. He's talking with Terry Robiski there on the sideline. Looks like an extra tight end. Do we see Marcus Allen again?
In comes David Jones, who is kind of a half and half, a tight end wide receiver type. And Marcus. And time running out on Schrader. Allen, who else? And it'll depend on the spot. It looked as if he made it to the 30. That would be a first down. But they're spotting it to way short of the 30. And based on the linesman's left foot, I don't think Marcus made it.
Not even close. Again, though, a crucial play, and the guy that carries it is Marcus Allen, the guy they don't want out there.
But under limited circumstances, and the clock's running down, they were late getting the play in. And, part of the blame of the, if this one did fail, has to go to the sidelines.
Yep.
Seemed they had trouble even, they weren't really set in the formation with 4 seconds to go on the play clock, and there's the difference.
Goodness.
And the Eagles get the cheers from their fans, the defense, and the defense has earned it.
Hi, Super Dave Osborne here with Haeger wrinkle-free cotton pants. They look great right out of the dryer with no ironing, but Haeger's asked me to put them to the ultimate test.
I'll wear these pants through high-pressure jets, brushes, and dryers at 3 miles per hour.
Ready? Oh, we're out of time. I guess Haeger will have to pay me for another commercial.
Maybe not.
New Haeger wrinkle-free cottons. 100% cotton, 0% wrinkles.
They're still not wrinkled!
You're married, 2 kids, one on the way, a house, a dog, 5 on the way, loads of other responsibilities too numerous to count. And you want this. Doesn't make sense. But here is an interesting alternative that does. The new Volvo 850 GLT.
Eagles leading 24-3 thanks to a brilliant defensive effort again for Philadelphia. And Los Angeles knows how difficult it will be to rally because the Raiders all season long have not scored more than 21 points. So things not looking well on the black and silver, or silver and gray, as some are calling the Raiders, who are the oldest team in the league. Herschel Walker for a couple up the middle. So from Philadelphia, let's go to NFL Live. And Bob, Bill Belichick, does he know defense?
Probably up 28 hours last night figuring out what to do against the Houston Oilers.
The Giants' gift to Cleveland. Second down, Heath Sherman, the touchdown maker. By the way, his 30-yard touchdown run, the longest of the year, longest run of the season for Philadelphia. And Jim McMahon, of course, quarterback controversy is a game that the media loves to play. It's good fodder, but based on what I've seen, if I can throw a vote in, I don't see any reason why Rich Kotite wouldn't keep his promise, and Randall Cunningham will be the quarterback in Green Bay next week.
Absolutely. Next week's choice of the starting quarterback has nothing to do with the football team, Randall Cunningham, or Jim McMahon. It is the promise. Next week, Rich Kotite keeps a promise, tells the truth, puts his quarterback, Randall Cunningham, back in the lineup.
Walker struggles and has the first down at the 42-yard line. Now, that won't make Jim McMahon very happy.
Well, but one of the things that I'm sure you'll remember, when we were talking to the Eagle players, we asked about Buddy Ryan. And they all said he was upfront with us. He told us the truth. He never tried to trick us.
Even if we didn't like the truth.
Yeah. Well, Rich Kotite has the opportunity to tell the truth next week. I mean, coaches do have to kind of bend things, and Kotite thought overnight about whether or not Cunningham starts this week. Told him on Monday, you're not. And next week, he just simply keeps a promise to Randall Cunningham.
He said, "Is my man's in a slump. It's like a hitter. I'm not going to let you face these pitchers. They'll give you a rest this series, and you start next week." First down, Walker. And the Eagles running with more enthusiasm now as we're down to the final minute of the third quarter.
Nice little counter run by the Philadelphia Eagles. If you want to continue talking about Randall Cunningham, McMahon told us, normally Randall takes 100% of the snaps during the week. This week, he took 50% of the snaps.
Even though McMahon was the starting quarterback, yeah, he didn't get all the reps.
And he says, "I don't mind. I'm not a big practice guy. I watch film. You know, I kind of get in my head what we're going
to
do."
Not even a good film guy.
No, he's not.
I like to watch film.
No. He plays dominoes, goes out with the offensive lineman, hangs out with the family and kids.
He says, he said, "Dicta thought I did all those things just to make him crazy. He said, I just like to amuse myself. I wasn't trying to upset Mike."
No.
We'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Tonight, Michael J. Fox and James Woods in the buddy movie of the year.
You a maniacal little cockroach. What am I doing?
The television premiere, The Hard Way, NBC Tonight.
Since the Honda Accord is America's best-selling car, why would you want to lease one? Well, for one thing, you won't have to drop a lot of cash. Introducing the Accord Lease Program. See your nearest dealer for details.
Silo presents Carl Lewis.
When your camcorder jumps around, so does a picture, and that's bad. But this Panasonic Palm Quarter camcorder has digital image stabilization. Okay, switch it on. See? It holds a picture steady, even if your hand jumps around this much. The Panasonic Palm Quarter is VHS, so its taste can play in your VHS recorder and everyone else's.
And now it's available at Silo.
The Panasonic Palm Quarter.
On sale now at Silo.
It's said that by the end of this century, Japan will have a stranglehold on the technology for automobiles, semiconductors, fiber optics, steel, and half the new patents in the world. Isn't it ironic? When Japan needed the technology for a new stock market, they found it in a stock market Americans have had for 20 years. The NASDAQ stock market.
Howard Eskin with sports. Weekdays on Newsday.
Young Todd Marinovic, 23 years old, free spirit, much like Jim McMahon. Their personalities are comparable. Will he be the quarterback next Sunday in the Coliseum when the Raiders host Seattle? Learning every week, he says. The Eagles and their defense have been at the head of the class at the Vet today. Not a first down. It'll bring up third and less than a yard. Jim McMahon did the game for NBC. Let's see, it's 8 years ago now. Goodness. When McMahon and the Raiders, it's the most vicious hitting game I've ever seen. And that was where the quarterbacks of the Raiders were being carted off one after another. David Hum broke a jaw and a leg or something all in one play. McMahon seemed to be not as seriously injured and almost died. Had a ruptured kidney. He said he didn't know how bad it was. They tried to remove his kidney, and he argued with the doctor that wouldn't let him do it.
Talked him out of it. Five lacerations of his kidney. I mean, the body cavity was filling up with blood, and this guy, he went back into the game, which is unbelievable.
Well, he's, in many ways, he is an unbelievable type. For whatever reason, a timeout called by the Eagles.
Wouldn't it be great if you could afford a luxurious mansion? For you and all your friends? Of course, the place needed some updates, like a bowling alley and a pool table. Naturally, it'd have an open house.
Food's here!
With beer!
Harold, do something!
Icy, cold-filtered Keystone, Keystone Light, and Keystone Dry. Bottle beer cased in a can. Now, wouldn't that be great?
Ooh, darling, I need you so. Never ever gonna let you go. Cause I'm the one, one for you. Hey, I'm the one.
Capture the ones you love without missing out on the fun yourself with a Sony Handycam, America's most popular camcorder.
He's back.
This time we get it.
STP Gas Treatment. Cleans intake valves and fuel injectors to help engines run better. STP, the edge.
If your face was square, shaving would be simple. But your face has curves. Presenting the revolutionary Schick Tracer. The only twin-blade razor that flexes to follow the curves of your face. Schick Tracer. We're changing the face of shaving.
Wednesday, does a videotape always show the truth?
It was self-defense. It was an execution.
Torn from today's headlines, an all-new Law & Order NBC Wednesday.
Well, the Raiders' quality for so many years, their all-time rusher, Marcus Allen.
He would be a perfect acquisition next year for the Philadelphia Eagles. A great compliment to Randall Cunningham.
How about the 49ers?
Them too. A lot of teams would be interested in using Marcus Allen a lot more than the Raiders do.
There was a rumor San Francisco wanted him. And this is a third and one, and Herschel Walker pulling his way easily for the first down to the Los Angeles Raider 44-yard line, and the clock will run. 14 minutes to go in a day which the Eagles have survived their star quarterback, Randall Cunningham, having a week off. He makes a approximately $125,000 a game, and so he'll just go to the bank with a smile and say, hey, guess, got a feeling that next week everything will all be patched up, except that McMahon might stir the pot a little.
He wouldn't.
If I were a writer, I'd go to McMahon about Wednesday. I bet I'd get a story.
Well, he would do that? Well, he might be on the sideline next week with a headband that says Randall on the front of it. You never know.
There's Mr. Howie Long. saying, I can play a little D myself.
Yeah. You know, Dick, you mentioned Howie Long has played an excellent game. I mean, a lot of things have not worked well for the Los Angeles Raiders, but Long has played possessed. Makes the tackle on Herschel Walker. You mentioned Randall Cunningham. When we came in here, we thought the world had stopped for Randall Cunningham. But the first time he walked into the locker room, he was playing video football against Herschel Walker, enjoying himself in his own surroundings. We asked how to go on the video football game. He says, I won. First good thing that's happened to me this week.
On second down. Out of the backfield to Sherman. Touchdown run and makes something out of very little. It'll be third down and about three.
We've seen a lot of Heath Sherman. The only comment I can make for the absence of Keith Byers may be that broken hand that he's wearing, that he's had to deal with.
His right hand.
Yeah, has a cast outside of a little glove. May be bothering him. Normally, this guy on offense does not leave the field.
He is left-handed, so he's able to play, and it doesn't hamper him as much as if he were a right-handed player. But this might be Kotite with a lead, giving an important player a rest.
Yep.
On third down, Walker. And it was Nolan Harrison, but the tackle made by Aaron Wallace. As the play misfires, and the Eagles will have to punt it to Los Angeles.
I don't understand what's keeping these people here in the stands. Maybe on the sunny side they're very nice and warm. I'm not sure. I guess they're here to see the Eagles go 5-0 at home in 1992.
There are some places where people pay a healthy price to go see an NFL game and leave in the third period, but these are fans in Philadelphia.
Hardy fans. You're talking about West Coast people who leave.
I didn't say where. You said. I've got to go back to the West Coast. Leave me alone. Tim Brown at the, I never leave early, 13-yard line, and they sit and smile in Philly.
Art historians will tell you it isn't unusual for a masterpiece to have been painted directly on top of another equally impressive painting, which itself was often painted on top of a third. This masterpiece, however, is the result of an exclusive 23-step paint process, the Acura Legend. Our intention was not merely to create a thing of beauty, but to create one that will stand the test of time.
My business, my hair has to look great. And even one flake is one too many. So I use New Head & Shoulders. It gets to 10 times more the places where dandruff starts. New Head & Shoulders. Because great hair can't have flakes.
Here's how the mind reacts to two pizzas for $5.99. Shock. Disbelief. Denial. And finally, acceptance. Now at Little Caesars, two pizzas for $5.99.
Doozy doozy.
If your business relies on 800 service, you may think of your phone line as your lifeline. So choosing AT&T 800 service is important. With another carrier, you could lose more 800 calls day in and day out, and they're twice as likely to have an outage. But relax. With AT&T, the most reliable 800 service, you can get more 800 sales and a healthier bottom line.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Acura Automobiles. Experience precision crafted performance. By Castrol GTX, engineered for today's smaller cars. By new improved Head & Shoulders, now it works even better to prevent flakes. And by AT&T, the right choice.
Face of Philadelphia. Fans. Now those are the real fans. Oh! Even the Raider fans down by three touchdowns from this area stay to the end. 11 minutes to go, and Schrader goes long for right. Almost number five, John Booty. Boy, did you see Wright, though, in about the last 15 yards, just pull away. Did he shoot into the open? Booty had him covered, played him 5 yards ahead until now.
And you could certainly tell the respect. scouting reports are given to players, and Booty knows how fast Alexander Wright was. The minute the ball was snapped, he was backing up hard. Not going to get by me.
Well, they like that stretch.
Goodness.
Long, long pass, and Schrader. Look at that, only 73 yards total passing offense for the Raiders today. Schrader, oh, not close. Ethan Horton was open. But Schrader was moving away from pressure.
Bud Carson, the defensive coordinator of the Philadelphia Eagles, kind of called off the dogs here on his defense, and the Raiders still can't make a completion.
Bud Carson, who had a chance finally to be a head coach for the Browns, not successful, but recognized around the league as one of the really brilliant defensive coordinators, and always has been.
Let me tell you something. After this play, let me tell you something about Bud Carson.
Look at some of his pupils, the Steel Curtain. How about the Rams in the late 70s? Deflected at the line of scrimmage. Reggie White in on top of Jay Schrader. And Mike Flores there as well. There's White, the Minister of Defense.
That's on Todd Peet, 64. Help from Mosbar, still able to get his hands up. You wonder why his sack total is not higher? That's two monsters, right? That's 650 pounds of meat in front of Reggie, and he still has an effect on the outcome of the play.
Eagles opponent next Sunday, losing to the Giants 13-7 in the fourth quarter. Short kick. Bassett has not had a good day. Ball down at the 40-yard line, so the Eagles once again begin action in Los Angeles territory. Three games yet to come, and here's the lineup. Most of you will see the Steelers and the Bills, two of the top teams in the AFC. San Diego, four in a row from an 0-4 start for Bobby Ross at Kansas City, where Marty Schottenheimer is trying to get the Chiefs back in gear. And the New York Jets, such a disappointing season, but a big win against Miami. Against the top team in the West, the Denver Broncos. Stay with us. Those games follow here on our doubleheader weekend. Rich Kotite, who is a University of Miami boxing champion. His dad was a manager of fighters in Brooklyn. Grew up around the various gyms.
Said he got in a ring with Kid Gavilan?
No, with Muhammad Ali, actually. Sparred with Ali at one time, but Gavilan was his favorite as a kid growing up, the bolo-punching Kid Gavilan.
Doesn't look like your ex-fighter, you know?
Didn't take enough punches.
Yeah, not enough bend in that nose. But
it tells you about his personality.
Though. Yes. This coaching staff is basically an AFC coaching staff. Richie was with the New York Jets for a number of years. Zeke Bradkowski, of course, coached with the Jets. Bud Carson with the Jets. A lot of AFC connection on this Philadelphia Eagles coaching staff.
Second and six for McMahon as the Eagles with a 24-3 cushion. Give it to Heath Sherman for maybe a yard. Ronnie Lott comes up to make the tackle along with Willie Broughton.
This has to kill Ronnie Lott. Being in this situation too often this season, actually including last year with the Los Angeles Raiders, this is not what he came to the Los Angeles Raiders to be a part of.
When they asked him about coaching, the name Bill Walsh came up, and he was free to admit, he said, you know, for many years I didn't understand Bill Walsh, didn't agree with him. He said, now I do.
Yeah.
Now I understand. He was on another level. He was so far ahead of where my thinking process happened to be at the time.
Well, I guess when you get closer to the end of your athletic career, you start to reassess those people you come in contact with and understand them a little better.
Man, going long. Lots of push and shove between Lionel Washington and Fred Barnett, but no flag.
Now, I'm not sure the fans should be booing here. There was as much contact offense to defense as there was defense to offense. Just let it go. Go back in the huddle. Watch the left arm of Barnett. Yes, sir. So the fans don't have the benefit of slow motion instant replay.
Although Washington wasn't exactly playing the ball. Fiegels and the punting team come on. at the 10. And they'll take the delay of game. Gives us a chance just to duck in a little note just to follow up on the Ronnie Lott, Bill Walsh. And then Will Rogers has said that after he was 21, every day of his life, his father became all the smarter. And someday I may even forgive him.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's true of Lott here now at the end of his tremendous career and perhaps the consummate defensive back. Certainly his place reserved in Canton, Ohio. That he understands more now the growing respect for some of those that he might have fought as a leader. Finkel's aiming for the coffin corner, but lands in the end zone. Los Angeles Raiders will get another opportunity down by 21.
When your engine is working hardest and needs protection most, Castrol GTX is the only leading motor oil that meets the world's toughest requirements for viscosity breakdown in every grade. Fact is, the only way you can get that kind of performance from any other leading brand of oil is like this. Castrol GTX, engineered for today's smaller cars.
Try Castrol Super Clean for tough, greasy jobs. If it won't come clean with Super Clean, it won't come clean.
Some automakers would have you believe that total isolation from the road is the ultimate luxury. But the Acura Legend was designed for a very different type of driver. One who believes that if a luxury car completely isolates you from the driving experience, it isn't really a driving experience.
My last business trip was
nowhere.
The most unusual.
The middle of nowhere.
Every day, 2 million travelers set out to do business.
Last year I traveled 65 days.
Who would know better what they need than Holiday Inn?
I always rehearse my presentation.
I always rehearse my presentation.
I always
in front of the bedroom mirror.
Bathroom mirror.
We make them feel welcome in so many ways. Maybe that's why more business travelers stay with us than anyone else.
What I miss most is my children.
Holiday Inn. Stay with someone you know who really knows you.
One's an actor, one's a cop. Now they're stuck with each other.
No way on earth I am going to babysit some Hollywood rump brain.
I'm sensing that you're not completely happy with this situation.
There's something a little different about our car.
If you can't trust your partner, who can you trust?
A television premiere, Michael J. Fox and James Woods, The Hard Way, tonight on NBC.
Eagles 24, the Raiders 3. The defense has been key to the success of the home team, and but Carson's group has played as expected, very tough at home.
I have a feeling Rich Kotite talked to Bud Carson about benching his quarterback. I'll tell you why in a minute.
Schrader looking for something and can't find Tim Brown. Eric Allen looking for the hat trick, has two interceptions already.
When Bud Carson was the head coach of the Cleveland Browns, he made the decision to pull Bernie Kosar from a football game and put Mike Pagel in as a starter. This was after a Friday practice and before a Sunday game. He got fired. They were not having a particularly good season, but he did not inform Art Modell and was held accountable for that. And the next Tuesday, he was gone. That's why I think Richie Kotite may have gone to Bud Carson and said, counsel me through this. What should I do?
Well, this is just a game now where you wonder who's going to catch each ball. The Eagles seem to have almost an equal chance at everything that's in the air, and the Raiders should know where it's going, and the Eagles just following the action, and look at the numbers. 9 completions on the entire day for the combined attack out of 29 chances. 9 for 29.
9 completions, 4 interceptions. Goodness.
And there have been 4 or 5 others with Eagle defenders had their hands on.
Yeah.
5 straight balls hitting the ground for Schrader. Steps away from Reggie White. Eric Allen runs him out at the 25-yard line. Well, the only quarterback controversy in Los Angeles will be whether Vince Evans will start.
Oh.
Vince Evans, who has been off and on the Raider payroll more times than a bad tightrope walker in a circus. I mean, he just up and down and up and down.
Wait. You're not getting out. Is this a swipe at the Seattle Seahawks starting next week?
Illegal use of the hands to the face.
No,
number 64
all.
On the offense. The penalty is declined. The result of the play, fourth down.
No, it's just a matter. You got to think as Pete gets the penalty that Todd Marinovich, they'll return home in the Coliseum. It'll be nice, warm weather, the friendly confines, and Marinovich, the young quarterback, based on what's happened today to Schrader, will be back as a starter, don't you think?
Yeah, actually, Todd Marinovich might have helped USC yesterday against Stanford more than he's helped the Raiders today against the Eagles.
Kick by Gossett to Sikahima. They overrun Elvis Patterson, the kick, and Sikahima to the 47-yard line, a 37-yard punt, 9-yard return. A long day for that man.
Yo, this is Jazzy Jeff. And how did I get my starter hat to look like this? The Jazzy Jeff breakdown. First you grab the hat, then you grip the hat, then you flip the hat. Make sure it's a starter hat. Then you raise the hat, then you slam the hat. Then you twist the hat. Then you turn the hat. Then you spin the hat. Then you smooth the hat. But hey, don't forget, look for the star.
Some of us are self-cleaning. Some of us aren't. Clean, not so clean. Groomed, oh well. Oddly enough, it's the same with water heaters. Some don't care how messy they are, but State water heaters self-clean with a patented way to prevent harmful sediment buildup. And since they use natural gas, they heat water for half the cost of electricity. For those other self-cleaners. Clean natural gas, America's best energy value.
No, that's too big. No, that's too weird. Too many tickets. Ah, the 1993 Acura Integra. Just the right amount of comfort, styling, and performance. And starting at around $13,000, it's not too expensive either.
She's from the future. She can assume any form. And she's evil. Now she's finally here.
Make love to me, Sam.
And Sam's in too deep.
Tell me that you don't want me.
To stop.
She's evil.
The Evil Leaper lands. Quantum Leap, NBC Tuesday.
The Eagles 24, the Raiders 3. And if you're just joining us, the score does not reflect any offensive explosion under Jim McMahon, the quarterback who has replaced Randall Cunningham, but more the defense of the Eagles totally shutting out the Raiders and giving the Eagles excellent opportunities to score. McMahon close enough to Sherman to avoid the penalty, and Howie Long, a ray of bright Los Angeles sunshine on this Philadelphia day on defense. He has played a big game, and we have an injured player for the Raiders.
Nolan Harrison, 74, I think, is on the ground, but I think it's a testimonial to the character of one Howie Long. Things are not going well for his defense. He never stops trying.
If you look at the other scores, the Giants adding to their lead against the Packers. Looked like Harrison was starting to get up and then just fell back down as if he might have taken either a blow to the head or a knee or a leg gave out.
Can't really tell. He's got both legs bent. Normally, if there's something wrong with a leg or a knee, see if he's limping at all there. George Anderson and the sunglasses on the right. Last year as the trainer of the Los Angeles Raiders. Been there for 1,050 years. Or 33. He's walking.
Yeah, it looks as if he might have been hit in the helmet.
Oh, I think he got KO'd by Ron Heller. I think we found out Harrison may be a great player, but watch what happens with Heller latter stages of this particular pass rush. He gets a shot right to the chin right there. In Richie Kotite's terms, that's called a glass jaw, I think.
On the button. tackle Walker across the 50 to the Raider 47. Winston Moss and others with the tackle.
So what do the Raiders build on from here? What have they done? Is there something to take into next week's game or for the rest of the season to start the second half of, this 92 season?
They're going
to
be 3-6. They're in a division that seems to be begging for someone to take grasp and be the top team. Denver is 5-3. Denver should lose to the Jets. The Raiders, even with this performance today, are only two games out of first place. Slingshot Schneiderman said the one thing they can take out of here is they don't have to come back to Philadelphia. That's good news.
That is good news.
McMahon wide open. Sekahema. Flag is down as Sekahema has a first down at the 25. Does it count?
That looked more like Randall Cunningham, didn't it? Rolling out there, throwing that thing down the field. It was not very pretty. Had a certain amount of end over end to it.
Yeah, he's a Jim McMahon, a rebel of sorts. Let's see what happens.
Holding number 36 in the defense prior to the completion of a pass. The penalty will be declined. The result of the play, first down.
Terry McDaniel trying to halt one of the receivers. So the play will count at the 25-yard line. First down, Eagles.
McDaniel right here going down the field. Yeah, there's the holding. It's on Roy Green, 81. Sekahema makes the completion, 22-yard pickup. And the list of positive things for the Raiders out of this game getting shorter and shorter.
7 minutes to go. Fake to Herschel Walker. A good fake by McMahon. Now he has to hurry his throw to Barnett. Incomplete. Barnett for the third time. Just a half step from a touchdown.
McMahon rolled out. Cunningham would have run that ball for 20 yards. McMahon threw it. That is the magic part of Randall Cunningham. Just an elegant runner.
Well, he's the all-time rushing quarterback. He's passed the Hall of Famer Fran Tarkenton, and he did in less than 7 years. Would have took Tark 18 to scramble to. Wilbert Montgomery and Steve Van Buren have run for more yards to the Eagles than a quarterback. Come on. Keith Sherman. Down at the 1 yard line. Ronnie Lund saved the touchdown. So Sherman, a 30-yard touchdown run earlier and 24 on this one.
Again, the Statue of Liberty play, and we should be able to see it perfectly. Watching Big Light the pass. Hands to Heath Sherman. Runs by Andre Bruce, 56. Fakes out Lionel Washington, 48. This guy's not used to carrying the ball this much. Lot puts him on the ground along with Anthony Bell, 59. First and goal, Philadelphia.
He had 86 yards on the season, Heath Sherman. And he's got 66 today. Well, you ought to give him a chance for another touchdown.
Absolutely. That's only justice.
Nope, it's Herschel. Second of the game, both from a yard out.
Oh, Dick, this score is 30-3. And with the field position and the turnovers, the Eagles had in the first half, it could have literally been 42-47-3. I mean, that's how badly the Raiders have been beaten today.
Rozek's try for point. 31-3. Ran Randall Cunningham said, don't score them all today. Package up a couple of those scores for Green Bay.
If you could see inside your suitcase when you travel, you'd see how Samsonite Hardside protects what's inside. Because Samsonite has a crush-resistant outer shell and a durable hardside construction that's designed to hold up over the long haul.
Daddy, did you bring me anything?
Samsonite Hardside. After all, you've got your life in there.
Jim McMahon. We're talking about the rebel with a cause with the Bears in their Super Bowl year. And remember the headbands?
Yes.
And Roselle, even it, he took it right to the top.
Absolutely.
He took it to Ditka. He took it to Roselle. He says, what do I need to watch film for? That's not what you see in a game. I get an idea. I know what the game plan is. They say he has a photographic mind, that he just remembers everything he sees. But he does, while everyone else is watching film of games at home to study opponents, he goes to the movie house because he loves the cinema.
And he likes Jack Nicholson.
That figures that.
Yes. Those two could probably entertain each other for months. So he had a chance to play with Jack Nicholson, and Nicholson had to cancel one time. The one round of golf he was so looking forward to get to know Jack Nicholson personally.
Here's his next kick. Alexander Wright won't return this one. Key college game on NBC Saturday next, and it'll pit two of the game's top coaches. Lou Holtz. He needs a win against Joe Paterno, the Nittany Lions and the Fighting Irish, next Saturday at 1 o'clock. Notre Dame with one loss to Stanford.
Am I correct?
And a tie with Michigan.
I'm sorry, Dick. Am I correct? This is the last time in a regular season Penn State and Notre Dame will meet?
Well, in the near future.
The Big Ten. Yeah,
right, in the near future. So this will call up a lot of memories.
Absolutely. Sure.
Look on Lott's face is, how can this happen? How can we be so ineffective? Underneath Andrew Glover, who earns a tough 5 yards, John Booty with a tackle. And Schrader going in a no-huddle offense with a 5:30 to go and looking at least for something cosmetic. The Eagles will be 6-3, but still trail Dallas by two full games. The Cowboys winning big today. Minnesota top of Central winning easily today. We'll see them next week against Houston. It's New Orleans winning big, so pressure on San Francisco for a victory to hold a share of the Western lead. Miami winning big, so Buffalo, as they host the Steelers, needs a win there to stay even with the Dolphins. Second half of our doubleheader carries a lot of important implications, and of course all the other scores, and Bob and the crew back in New York will keep you abreast of all the highlights and scores, so stay with us. Reggie White fumble. And it's finally covered, I believe, by Reggie McElroy. And Clyde Simmons actually has the ball, and it's Simmons who took it away from McElroy at the last minute.
I mean, it's 31-3. Reggie White is still coming on the pass rush. Right side of the screen, goes around McElroy, through him, bats the ball out of the hand of Jay Schrader. And there's 5:02 to go in the game, 31-3. Boy, you're right. Clyde Simmons, McElroy missed it. Clyde Simmons right on that football.
Boy.
5 turnovers today by the Raiders.
Both teams treated that fumble like the ball was contaminated. You check the other scores, and the rich getting richer today in the NFL. Miami has made it official, a shutout of the Colts, getting revenge from the Colts win 2 weeks ago down in South Florida. That's the big surprise of the day. Minnesota has beaten Tampa Bay. Herschel Walker going to the 10-yard line.
Good gravy. Did you see Nolan Harrison get hit by Herschel Walker? He got another shot right on that glass jaw. Look at it. Where am I? This is a good game to forget. If you're going to get knocked out of a game, this is one that you don't mind getting.
You always come up with something positive.
Absolutely.
I admire that in you.
Watch this, 74, Kiss. I'm out of here. Yes, just put me in with the uniforms, cleats, and shoulder pads. I've forgotten this weekend. Get me back to the left coast.
The left coast. 65,388 partisan Eagle fans, and this was an important win for this franchise. And they won those first four and were so successful on Monday night in their fourth straight win against the Cowboys. Super Bowl talk was free around the city of brotherly love. And they lose 3 out of 4, and they change quarterbacks. And after today, everything will seem very rosy. McMahon, one-handed try by Pat Beach. Tight end, played at Washington State. His daddy, still the pharmacist there in Pullman, Washington.
Glad to be a part of a team like this, too. This kid has bounced around a lot, was at Indianapolis and lost every week for years and years and years. 10 years.
Went to the Jets, Plan B, and they released him.
And now he's with certainly a team that's going to be in the playoffs, and a lot of people here in Philadelphia, and rightly so, think that this is a Super Bowl contending team.
He's one guy that doesn't miss Keith Jackson.
Yes.
That opened up the opportunity for him. Man hit by his own man as he tried to throw the ball, and boy, you don't expect a blindside there. Herschel Walker on a miscommunication, and Walker smiling because McMahon may have swallowed his the stuff he chews.
Dick described this from, that's the hardest hit he's had all day, and it's his old guy. He limps off the field.
Randall Cunningham saying, nah, you're not going to make me put on the helmet now.
He's warming up.
Look at it. I've got a feel, just judging McMahon trying to wipe away a sneer, that the when they put out the NFL injury report, questionable, swallowed, and cut.
The one thing I like about McMahon, when you talk to him, if you don't stop him, he'll tell you Ditka stories until all your time is gone. He loves talking about Mike. He's now got a smile on his face. I imagine he might say something to Herschel when he gets to the huddle.
Say, Herschel, I know you're a friend of Randall Cunningham, but come on, not right out in the open like that, isn't that a bit obvious?
There's Herschel.
Oh, if you only could have a microphone there. Yes. Now.
Reading lips.
He told us about Ditka. He'd say, Ditka'd send in a play, and he said, fellas, don't even look at the sidelines. I'm changing the play. And he said, before we broke, got the snap, and Ditka knew we were in the wrong formation. You could hear him swearing from the sidelines.
Even in the Metrodome, where it gets so noisy, you can still hear him.
Walker feels his way on fourth down inside the 10, but did not make the first down, I don't believe. I know you're waiting for this, Bob. I know you're really
waiting for this.
Tonight, a special two-hour all-new Secret Service, starting at 7, 6 Central, based actually on an actual case, the plot to kill the president. Apparently crashing a jet airplane into the White House was the scheme. Then the network television premiere of the box office hit The Hard Way stars Michael J. Fox. James Woods team up in an action thriller tonight on NBC. Kind of like Enberg and Trumpy in this action thriller from
the
Philadelphia.
Hard Way. Yes, that's true. So let's ask Richie Cunningham. Do we agree your starting quarterback next week is Randall Cunningham? No question whatsoever.
In many ways it was... Yeah, we make too much out of the whole quarterback thing. And, hey, what's wrong with the coach saying you're a star, but you're not playing very well? Just give me a weekend. Reggie White meets Marcus Allen. And you can't tell White that they're ahead 31-3, and there's only 4 minutes to go. He's still doing what he enjoys best.
This is almost criminal. I mean, the offense today for the Los Angeles Raiders have done little or nothing, and it's all because of the quality of the Philadelphia Eagles defense. Marcus on the sideline, a very comfortable spot playing these guys in green.
Schrader. His pass intercepted by one of the men. No, that's a Raider fan. It was intercepted by an Eagle police officer who's still running.
Now that guy's dressed to go to work, isn't he?
That's a serious costume. Boy, this is a... It's a terrific sports city, Philadelphia. I mean, it doesn't matter. The Phillies or the Flyers or these Eagles. I mean, they take... It's a big city, but it takes its professional sports with the seriousness of a college town. Underneath. And, you know, they don't want to just win. I mean, they really want it to be 100-0 if you can do it. That's who stays here now.
Yeah, they take it personally here, too. I mean... Mike Schmidt has had to come out when he played with the Philadelphia Phillies. He's had to come out with a wig on. When he says something about the Philadelphia fans, they say they'll boo Santa Claus in Philadelphia. These are personal, well, maybe not him, but these people take sports in Philadelphia personally.
They go out to the big parks on the Easter egg hunt and boo the kids who don't find any. Total offense for the Raiders. 81 passing, 66 running, and Nick Bell, the young man from Iowa, finally gets a chance, and many wonder why doesn't he play more, including Nick Bell, and he'll get that run plus 15 on a late hit.
Well, they got him in there not a moment too soon either, right, to be a factor in this game, didn't they?
Nick Bell is 253 pounds. Second-year man from Iowa. His average this year, 5.7 a carry. That includes a 66-yard touchdown run against Seattle. He gets 24 on his first attempt today. Now, if there's any controversy, it's over the running backs. I mean, is Eric Dickerson really the man to run the ball for the Raiders? I think that question needs to be asked.
It's not answered yet, that's for sure.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, a late hit out of bounds, number 38 on the defense. 15 yards will be tacked on to the end of the play. First down.
Well, you see the end of the run. That's Eric Allen trying to get that big fella out of bounds. And then the hit. There's no question about that.
I ask Al Davis, after the Raiders won their first game of the year, beat the Giants, they were 1-4. I said, are you too old? You're the oldest team in the league. Are you too old? He said, I'll know at the bye week. The bye week was last week. I'll tell you. And yesterday said, I'm not sure yet. It's 3-5. And there's a little to-do back at the line of scrimmage.
Now, you know, to continue the story about Al Davis and are the Raiders too old, they went three of their last four. You can't make that decision.
Right.
They looked fine. But now sitting at 3-6. And Nick Bell tells us last night in the conversation we're sitting here, and he said 6 weeks ago, this was a job. I was not enjoying myself. I had to sit down and talk with Ronnie Lott. Ronnie Lott said to me, look, if you're only going to get three carries a game, make all three carries like they're in the Super Bowl. And he said it revived me. But why are these players psychologically in this situation?
First down for the Raiders inside the 15. The throw to Willie Gault. And Gault will be remembered on this day for starting things in the wrong direction for the Raiders by muffing a reception that went to the arms of Eager Eagle. And Andy Harmon's been into little push and shove for the last two plays. Harmon, the second-year defensive tackle from Kent State, and that's Todd Pete, who is big at 305, but not nearly as big as he was 7-8 months ago when he was close to 400 pounds. And he and Harmon said, hey, Ross Perot, I mean, I thought he was there.
What? I think Todd Pete is a little heavier than 305. He's replacing Max Montoya.
Yeah,
here's
continuing
a call.
Action fouls after the play is over. number 64 for Los Angeles Raiders is ejected. Number 91 for Philadelphia is ejected. The result of the play is a second down at the 6-yard line.
Geez, if they throw them out, there might be fights all over the place here for get both these teams' players on the bench.
So the Browns have upset the Houston Oilers.
That's amazing. In the Astrodome, that's shocking.
Now the Cleveland Browns go 5-4, very much a part of the Central Division race. 2:20 left in this game that has now boiled down to just some emotional frays. Harmon, he looks like an Andy Harmon, doesn't he?
Yes.
From Centerville, Ohio.
Certainly has the look of a defensive tackle.
Don't go wandering away just because this game's been lopsided. We've got some more coming for you in Pittsburgh and Buffalo. Figures to be a test of some of the elite of the AFC. Who will come out of that 7-2? The Chargers in Kansas City, Jets in Denver to follow here on NBC. Listen to these fans. They don't want the Raiders to score a touchdown. Tim Brown from Jay Schrader and Seth Joyner out there to cover. It'll bring up third down. Two to go for a first down from the 6-yard line.
I don't think there's any question that Jay Schrader will be back on the bench next week, just as you mentioned earlier. It's interesting that the quarterbacks that have played the majority of these games for their respective teams today will not start next week. Marinovich in the Cape.
Quarterbacks, excuse me, Bob, are 13 for 36. You think about the Raiders, you think about passing, execution, big plays. And this has been most disappointing for Raider fans. Inside goes the big guy, Nick Bell, and he shoved all the way back to the 7. They're going to mark its progress at the 6-yard line as we come to the 2-minute timeout. Will Archell's Raiders score against the Eagles? Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Art historians will tell you it isn't unusual for a masterpiece to have been painted directly on top of another equally impressive painting, which itself was often painted on top of a third. This masterpiece, however, is the result of an exclusive 23-step paint process, the Acura Legend. Our intention was not merely to create a thing of beauty, but to create one that will stand the test of time.
Nipper and Chipper show us what the RCA home theater with SRS sound looks like. Now they show us what it feels like. Looks like. Feels like. Looks like. Feels like. Any questions?
It's 30 below. You've got a cold, cough. You've got a real problem.
We've added the leading cough suppressant to the proven cold relief of Alka-Seltzer Plus.
I have no sneezes, no coughs, no runny nose. I took Alka-Seltzer Plus cold and cough this morning.
Alka-Seltzer Plus cold and cough. It's tough medicine.
This high-performance drink cleans your fuel system to help maintain peak performance. STP Gas Treatment. The high-performance drink for your car.
There's Al Davis. This might be a record. It's the latest Al Davis has ever had his close-up on an NBC telecast.
That's only because we couldn't find him. We weren't exactly sure where he was sitting.
The Raiders are the only offense in the league not completing more than 50% of their passes. 58% is the average. And today they're 13 for 36.
And you know, Al Davis will tell you, we've never been interested in the high completion percentage passer. We want to stretch the defense.
Fourth down and 2. For those who are left in Veterans Stadium, this is the big play. Schrader. Touchdown, Tim Schrader took a big hit just as he released the ball. And another fight breaks out. And the Eagles mad at the Raiders, and the Raiders react. These are two teams known for their aggressive play, and the Eagles chatted about that before the game. Said, hey, we got to be abusive, intimidating. That's the game is, what did Seth Turner say? This is not a game
for good guys.
For good guys.
This is a game
good
for boys. Bad guys.
So the touchdown, Schrader to Tim Brown, comes at the 155 mark in the final quarter.
You know, Dick, I'll get to it in a minute after the extra point here.
Gossett, the punter, holding for Jaeger. <laughs> 31-10. Schrader had to release the ball on that touchdown throw. Well, didn't have a fraction left. Here comes the pressure up the middle from Evans.
Nobody touches him. Nick Bell goes to the outside. He's not able to get a lot of steam on it, but Tim Brown does make the catch for the lone touchdown of the day by the Los Angeles Raiders to this point. I was about to comment. It does not look like to me, we have seen the Raiders now, what, four times this season? I don't know what they can do this year for the remainder of this year to make this football team better. I honestly don't. I mean, it's not like you can go to a backup quarterback, go to a new formation. I mean, Archell has tried all kinds of things to get more out of this football team.
The only thing he could do is start Nick Bell, say, hey, I'll go with the youngster, make him the man, that's our future, and see what he can do. But that, you know, that's not exactly, that's trying to throw one bag of sand in front of a riptide.
Unfortunately, I think one of Archell's big problems is he's not in a position to make that choice. It's not just what Archell thinks on this football team. It's created a lot of controversy. It's created a lot of misimpression, misinformation.
What are you saying?
That Al Davis makes a lot of decisions on this team, whether Archell likes him or not.
But you ask Al Davis that, and I have. He says, I am not the coach of the team. There's the coach. Art Shell's the coach of the team.
Well,
I'm just the manager, the owner-manager.
I've heard Art Shell say that to us. We've been in meetings where I've asked Art Shell, but Al Davis has his fingerprint on every single move Art Shell makes. I don't think Art makes it without his approval.
Well, but if that's the case, you'd have to say the same thing about Tom Flores and John Madden as the coaches, very successful coaches, that Al Davis had to have just as much a hand then, right?
Yes. Onside kick coming by the Los Angeles Raiders.
And it goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line. And that's where they'll play. Anything more on Al Davis?
No, I think that's... I think that's a problem on this football team. And Al Davis, 25 years ago, made an awful lot of very good decisions. There's no question about that. But I have a feeling that some of the decisions he's had made later, like sticking with players like Eric Dickerson, like Mark Wilson, they've hurt this franchise. This is not the Raider team that we saw in the 70s and early 80s, where they would just come to the line of scrimmage, and they may lose 31-10. But you go home bruised, beaten, and bloody. They don't beat anybody up at the line of scrimmage anymore like they used to. And Art Shell was one of the most aggressive, physical football players the Los Angeles Raiders have ever had. I don't like the direction the Raiders are going. Whether Al Davis has anything to do with it or not, it's not healthy.
Well, they'll go home 3-6, and perhaps it'll be the media in the West Coast that will have all the big stories next week. We'll see what happens. You're not running for office, are you? I mean, I just want to see what you...
No, two weeks ago, I made my last trip to Los Angeles for about the next 8 years, so... No, that's not true.
All right, the onside kick again. This one goes out of bounds, so this time they'll play it at the 35-yard line.
Great idea, though. Terrific idea.
Executive producer of NBC Sports is Terry O'Neill, the coordinating producer of NBC Football and the producer of today's game, John Ferratsis. This game directed by John Gonzalez, associate director Al Szymanski, Ed Fibishoff, the production associate, production manager Susan Stone. Keith Shamahorn is our technical manager and Mitch Geller, technical director. And the rest of the men and women who brought you our coverage from the Vet in Philadelphia. Now into November, and this 1992 season sorting itself out. There are some pretenders being identified.
Yeah, and contenders too. Like the Eagles are now 5-0 at home in 1992. Jim McMahon will watch Randall Cunningham start and play next week against Green Bay.
Chance to thank those in the booth today: Rush Schneiderman, Keith Gallagher, Mike McKay.
We've got back-to-back out-of-bounds onside kicks being discussed here by referee White.
Well, the first one went out of bounds, and I figured that since you kicked the ball out of bounds, would have been at the 35-yard line. And those are the Raiders booing. They said, "We got a plane to catch here."
Illegal formation on a kickoff. Well, this game is complete. Nothing else can happen here. We're done.
We have 1 minute and 55 seconds remaining. The Eagles have...
Personal foul on the kicking team. Personal foul, number 25. That penalty is declined. We have a kickoff out of bounds, which went greater than 30 yards. And by rule, they're entitled to the ball 30 yards from where it was kicked. They have elected to take the result of the play, first down.
Wait a minute. And then they give you the ball at the 25-yard line, when if you kick the ball out of bounds in the first place, you get it at the 35. Plus, the team that kicked the ball committed a personal foul, unless the foul was against the Eagles. Oh, I see. They kicked the ball from the 50-yard line because of the original foul. And so you have the 30 yards, make the 20.
You makes sense, it out. Makes sense to me, Dick.
You
makes
figure
sense
it out.
To me.
Who cares? It's up to McMahon and the Eagles to run out the clock. He's Sherman. He's been a key part of this game. A 30-yard touchdown run, but the Hager wrinkle-free cotton super play of the game was this touchdown pass from McMahon to Fred Barnett that took the Eagles to a 17-3 just lead just before halftime. Perfect articulation between the thrower and receiver.
Against the defense, a coverage that's designed for one thing: stop that pass. The go pattern straight up the field. Eddie Anderson did not get over on the coverage.
Fred Barnett's fifth touchdown reception of the year. He's certainly a free spirit from Gunnison, Mississippi. 702 population. Sherman running like a tank. And falls on his fumble after the first down out across the 30-yard line. 12 more yards for Heath Sherman is going to match his total of the first eight games of the season today. 81 today, 86 for the year. Pittsburgh, Buffalo, San Diego, Kansas City, the Jets and Denver are next on our doubleheader coverage on NBC. Stay with us. And, of course, all the crew back at NFL Live in New York will have the top scores and highlights for you.
The only drama left in this football game, Dick, is once this game is over and Rich Kotite gets to the press room, how long will it take for somebody to ask, who's your starting quarterback next week?
Second question.
Second?
The
What's
second
the
question.
First?
Won't be, well, the first will just be, you know, how'd you like the day? Nice win. And then they'll ask them the question. Randall Cunningham, Rich Kotite. I mean, all the right signs are there. They've won. That eases any pressure. McMahon was okay, but it wasn't brilliant. It was the defense that won this game for the Philadelphia Eagles, 31-10. The Eagles 6-3. The Raiders 3-6. For Bob Trumpy, Dick Enberg, so long from Veterans Stadium, Philadelphia.